One of the experiences I trust every homebrewer shares is the feeling of awe that comes from witnessing the conversion of wort into beer through the fermentation process. Even after 15 years, I still get giddy when I see the first signs of airlock activity, a nice fluffy croissant developing on top of my beer. The worst is when this takes too long. Y'all know the anxiety that comes from checking on a batch a day after pitching and seeing no action. This is why we love Imperial Yeast, who pack 200 billion cells of the purest yeast into each pitch-right pouch, which assures quick starts, healthy fermentation, and predictably great results. I strongly urge all of our listeners to check out everything Imperial Yeast has to offer and let them know that you appreciate their support of the Brewlosophy podcast while you're at it. All right, on to the show. Hey, everybody, thank you so much for tuning in to this, the 100th episode of the Brewlosophy podcast. We've got something really fun planned. I think it's going to be fun. At least I'm your host, Marshall Schott. And joining me to celebrate the fact that we've reached the century mark are my friends and everyone's favorite beer reviewers, Jersey and Tim. We've got Craig in the house as well. We've got Tim's wife is hanging out with us. We're kind of just partying at my house today. Jersey, a lot's happened since our holiday episode. The last time you were on one of these live things, you spent 3 months away from home, but you're back now and hanging with us tonight, or today, I should
say.
Yeah,
a lot's happened. You replaced me.
Justin's on his way. He'll tag team with you as soon as he
breach
gets here.
Breach of contract is what's happened.
Yeah, there was somebody who said that he sounded like...
Patton Oswalt,
our food reviewer, right?
And well, of course, he is kind of chubby. Yeah.
Well, Patton Oswalt. Apparently, Patton Oswalt sounds a lot like. Well, Justin sounds a lot like Patton Oswalt, and so we did a comparison, and that guy was spot on. He sounds exactly like Patton Oswalt.
Watches a lot of King of Queens, apparently.
Well, Justin will be joining us later. He's prepping his tri-tips for our barbecue tonight. Of course, it wouldn't be a party without Timmy Tim. What's up, my friend?
What's up, guys?
So I realized something as I was planning for this show. You guys have been doing beer reviews since episode 8, which makes you, I feel like most people, you can tell I'm kind of losing my voice. I think it's the air quality these days, but I think most people actually listen to us because of you. And I know, Jersey,
I don't buy that.
I hate us.
I don't even listen
and
to us.
And when you said everybody's favorite beer reviews, I know for a fact there's a couple of people whose favorites we're not.
Well, there are a few. We might read some of those comments
that
later.
That would be amazing.
I don't even think I'm my favorite beer reviewer.
No, Tim's my favorite.
Yeah, out of the two of us, I like him better, too.
Yeah, he smells better, generally.
You know what that makes us? You said that makes us, and then you kind of trailed off. What does that make us? Just say it. I want you to say it.
It makes you Brewlosophy.
No, no, no.
You guys are
that's
the
not what I want to hear. You know what I want to hear.
Learned men.
Yes.
You guys are much, much learned men. Craig, what's up, my friend? Craig Fry is joining us again. You guys might recognize his voice from...
Kicking the Kegs.
It was Kicking the Kegs episode. Yeah. That's right. Yeah. We had... that was when Jersey was out.
From the What's Going Down episode of That's My Mama. You might remember him as Joe the Policeman from What's Going Down episode of That's My Mama.
Jesus.
Wow.
I love that movie.
Kicking the Kegs episode, and that was where we had Patton Oswalt on, and we replaced Jersey with Patton Oswalt because you were in Ukraine.
There is no replacement.
Can you turn your phone? What kind of professional are you?
I forgot we were in church.
Jeebus.
Yeah,
we're in a temple for sure.
Craig, what's been going on, man?
Drinking a lot of beer.
We just got back from
Vegas.
Vegas, yeah.
We drink a lot of Miller Lite, and we drink a lot of pool water.
Yeah, that nasty Vegas nasty. Pool water. We did have some really good Kolsch at what was it called? Banger Brewing.
The Kolsch of personality.
That was on Fremont Street. That was good.
Hey, we have that trademark, dude. We have that trademark if anybody decides to use it.
I will use that for my next Kolsch name. The Kolsch of personality. But we had a great time.
You also had some beers that you brought up when we were at the lunch place across the street.
I don't remember much about this trip. So anyways, we're broadcasting this. It was so good. We're broadcasting this this episode live to our private Brew Crew Facebook group.
All
see us right now. All four of them at this point. I think we might get 7 or 8 by the end of the day. It's open to all patrons of Brewlosophy, and we'll be taking questions from them throughout the show if they have questions, of course. Speaking of patrons, I want to give a huge cheers to everyone who's chosen to support us by making a monthly pledge over at patreon.com/brewlosophy. It's because of you that we've been able to make it this far. Patrons of Brewlosophy receive all sorts of cool rewards for helping us out financially. Things like access to the previously mentioned Facebook group, as well as never before published recipes from contributors, unique discounts to YakimaValleyHops.com, and an invitation to a monthly live Q&A with a special guest. Coming up in August is the late edition podcast host and hop expert. You guys know him, Caleb Schwecki from Yakima Valley Hops. Past guests have included John Palmer, Vinny Chalurzo, Gordon Strong, and many others. Learn more about becoming a patron over at patreon.com/brewlosophy. And thanks to everyone who's been using the links found at brewlosophy.com/support. It's been more helpful than you know. If you're looking for a pain-free way to help us out, consider using the links found on our support page when you do your online shopping, you guys. Great. No content. Yeah, I love you too.
Patrons of Brewlosophy.
All right, just a quick reminder for those looking to be a part of a rad group of science-minded homebrewers to consider joining the Brew Club, which has been growing very fast. I think there are over 600 members now. Membership is currently free, and all members have the opportunity to have their very own experiment published over at brewlosophy.com. You can head over to thebrewclub.com. That's the B-R-U club.
Umlaut.
There's no umlaut. You can't do that in so...
No umlaut. There's no umlaut.
No umlaut. It's the B-R... No, is that the,
you keep sending me invitations to join that. You know I don't brew.
I'm sending you invitations to join this right here that they're watching us on.
Okay, yeah. I'll join that.
So it's just people who like you. So thebrewclub.com.
There's no different.
Registration's free. All right, feedback this week is brought to you by Brewers Hardware, who are excited to offer brewers their beautiful BH15 Pilot Brewing System, a fully customizable turnkey rig that utilizes a hard plum manifold to make brewing more efficient by eliminating all hosing changes. Head over to brewershardware.com to check out all of their incredible stainless gear. And don't forget to mention Brewlosophy at checkout to receive a free gift.
Is it called a pilot brewing system? Because even a pilot could do it.
Yeah, the Jersey Brewing System.
Even a pilot can figure this out.
It's pilot.
Yeah, pilot. That's brewershardware.com. All right, feedback. I was trying to look for feedback that had to do with you guys, but everyone just kind of loves you.
Yeah, no, they don't.
So our last episode.
I know a couple people that don't.
But this sort of relates to all of us because we're all dads. So our last episode was the first in our Brews Views series. And the focus was on brewing and drinking as parents. You guys may not brew, but you certainly drink. I fully expected to get a lot of shit for the opinions that I shared on that show, but surprisingly, all of the feedback, and there was a ton of feedback at the end of the show, has been really positive. I got an email from this guy named Adam Adzi Shell. He's from Brisbane, Australia.
Hey, right, bring it on, mate.
Hello,
hi.
I thought it was pretty cool. I wanted to share it with everybody. He says, Adzi said, I listened to your latest podcast today and I needed to reach out. Like a lot of you, I have a young family. I work 6 days a week and I only get to brew on Sundays. With my partner working on Sundays, it's up to me to take care of our 3-year-old little man. Although he's young, he always wants to help, lifting milk crates, adding grain to the mash, measuring hops, and helping me bottle the small number I do to share with friends. He tries to lift the kegs, but can't just yet. I'm looking forward to that day. I'm with you. I believe the respect he's learning, not just from beer, but alcohol in general, brewing and socializing, and more than brewing beer provides, it's priceless. He says he's my number one brewery assistant, and I look forward to many years ahead with him. I need to keep an eye on him because, just like his dad, he enjoys beer. I think he's 4 years old. That's pretty cool.
I think he needs a beer.
I used to try and take a bigger swig of dad's beer when he wasn't watching. It's a shame you received such negative feedback on your photos with your kids. I'll tell you guys about that in a minute. Hopefully the negatives are behind now. Keep doing what you guys do. It's appreciated.
What's the negative feedback? Get that ugly dude out of the picture.
So what happened, I told this on the show. What happened was I put a picture of, I think it was Roscoe, holding a little glass of beer.
Awesome.
Well, this was years ago, though. Okay. You're thinking of the one with olive.
It's just the one in black and white.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that was brewing with me, but I put a picture of him like taking a swig of beer out of a little glass,
as he should.
In a, you know, that's what I'm saying, is it's okay for them to sample. And some dude private messaged me and said, you know, CPS could come to your house for that, and blah blah blah. And now I know that that's bullshit.
California Highway, California
Protective
Pacific
Services.
Oh.
The people who protect California.
Me too.
Also, children.
Yeah, I protect California.
You do. You're National Guard. So anyways, we appreciate your feedback, Adzi. If you have show feedback, you can send it to feedback@brewlosophy.com. Drop us a line on social media or leave us a message by calling 951-444-0322.
And maybe we'll run into you if we're ever in the Northern Territories again. Right.
So you spent some time in the Northern Territories.
I think so. I don't remember a lot of it.
Weren't you the only one in Guam for a while? Is that?
No, I only did it like 2 weeks in Guam. I was not the only one. But no, we spent Darwin. We spent some time in Darwin. It was fun.
That's awesome. Yeah. Why don't you, Jersey, what we're doing in this show is sort of your idea. And I figure we got a couple of breaks that we've got to take. But I figure what we'll do is we'll start with a couple of the beers because we got a lot of beer. We'll start with a couple of beers now. We'll take a break, refill, and recharge our cooler in here, and then we'll do more. Tell our audience what the plan is for this
show.
Don't
tell me what to do.
I'm not telling you. I'm asking you. Can you please?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Okay, I'd love to. Yeah. So way back in our friendship, I was just telling Laura this story, maybe 4 years or so ago. It was a while ago. Time with you, like, usually I do in a three-year assignment, I move places, and I know exactly when things were. But with you, it might have been 2 years. It may have been 5 years. I don't know. But I went out to your fridge and you had all these types of beer and I'm like, well, what do you want? And you're like, just pick me something. And you had, I think, about four different types of IPAs. And so I poured four different IPAs into four different glasses and brought them to you. I'm like, tell me which brand each of these is. And you stuck every single one of them except that you mixed up the last two. And I'm like, yeah, you're wrong on these last two. And you're like, no, I'm not. You're wrong. And so I went back and looked what I wrote and I was actually wrong. So he got 100% of them. And that was the seed, if you will, for this. Basically, this is Tim and I's best attempt at proving that was just, you just got lucky.
It's a fluke.
I tell you guys every time we're done doing beer reviews, so the way we do the reviews is in sessions. So we'll do, 10 beers in a session. And for some reason, it's become
hammered.
Yeah. Well, the end you are. Tim's asleep on the couch.
You can tell the ones that are towards the end of the session.
Well, yeah, Tim gets a tummy ache.
That's right. But usually, or what has ended up happening is that you guys, for some reason, think that it's your job to nail the style of beer.
No, not that it's our job, but you said we've been doing this for almost 100 episodes. Like, you would think.
You would think
we'd get to the point where we could at least get a reliable amount of these,
it's
right?
It's beer.
Yeah. But we misfire all the time. Which is why.
Actually, you guys have been right more than you've been wrong.
Which is why when we hit on one of them, dude, we get so excited.
It is fun.
Right?
It is
but
exciting.
This is a win-win for us, right? Because all you have to do is lose. Like, you have nothing to lose or nothing to win.
Well, there is a bet that you placed.
There's a bet. So the original bet, the terms of the bet are, if I lose, I'm buying you a nice steak dinner. And you have to dress up for this. I want a tie.
Ooh. And my Speedo?
Yeah, it's going to be a mandate.
And I think it should be Facebook Live.
I don't
want
to get kicked out of the place. We're going to Yosemite Ranch or something somewhere and get a nice steak. Yeah, me and you, bud.
Okay.
Timmy, you can have your own personal bet. This is just mine. But the terms of this bet are...
But you're invited. I invite you. I'll pay for you. Yeah.
How about this? We'll go the three of us and Timmy are... I'll buy you the steak, but Timmy has to go too.
Yeah.
So it's a mandate.
Yeah. It's a mandate. Yeah. Sorry, ladies.
Anybody can go that wants to go. I'm just buying one steak for Marshall. So the terms of this bet are this. I mean, it would be unrealistic for me to think you're not going to nail the style on every one of these beers. So the terms of this bet that you have to nail the style on, let's say, 90% of the beers. Like, you can miss on one or two, but you have to hit them all.
So how many do we have?
We've got...
Do we count them all?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. There might be about 14. So you got to get at least...
Now you know how we feel, Marshall.
You've got to guess the style. Like this is a X style.
I'll try.
On 12 out of the 14.
Okay.
That wins you the bet. Or if you can nail the exact, like, this is a Bud Light. Like, if you can nail the exact brand of the beer.
Okay.
Then if you can do that three times, you win. Those are my terms.
Oh, geez. All right.
So even if you miss fire on most of them and you don't get the style, if you can nail three of the, like, this is what this is, and it's right. Remember that time we guessed Guinness and it was right?
Yeah.
Right?
You guys have guessed a lot right. I get a lot of feedback from people saying how much you guys have grown.
So three. If you do that three times, you're like, this is Guinness, and it is.
Okay.
Then you win.
Okay.
Okay, now, so what happens if he wins? What happens?
I buy him a steak dinner. I'll buy both of you a steak dinner.
Ooh, whoa. Deal. I like that. I just made you money, bro.
The patrons, we need your help here because I don't think I'm going to win this. So.
I think you're totally.
I think the steak dinners there are only like 30.
I think you're totally not going to win it.
All right.
Do you
have at least one? Well, why don't you get pouring?
I know that you don't like to do this and you say that you don't do this, but you do. But, you know, like, prep the battle space. I'm just going to tell you that this is some exotic shit.
I have a feeling I'm not
going
to win this.
It's some exotic shit that you're not going to guess.
That's okay. That's okay.
All right.
So get going. I won't watch.
I'm so excited.
One thing for sure. One thing for sure. We're having a steak dinner.
That's all, Tim. That's all Tim gives a shit about. Now, here's the deal. We are not doing a Jersey and Tim beer review in this episode because Jersey, Tim, and Craig, and potentially, hopefully soon, Justin will be here as well.
3-hour beer review with Marshall and Marshall.
Send him a message.
Well, you guys are going to give your feedback as well. Yeah, that's what makes this fun.
Too, but we already know what it is.
Get to pouring so that we can get... I figure what we'll do is we'll do two of the beers before we head to a break, and then we'll go kind of recharge.
You have to... Like, you can't listen either, because if you hear it's a bottle, that's going to help skew... You know, bottle
that's
versus
not
going to
change.
It is!
Oh, Lord. I can't hear... I've got these on. I can't hear a thing, I promise you.
I don't know what to start with. I'm so excited.
Just random.
No, it can't be random. There's a plan.
He's
got to
close your eyes.
Close your eyes.
Yeah. Should we sing a song, Tim? So I would like to say, I would. I know Tim's away from the mic now. He's helping Jersey.
Keep your eyes closed. Do not
open. They're closed. I promise you they're closed. Now, here's the deal. The
I should get Laura's sleep mask.
I didn't see it. I promise I didn't see anything. I was trying to talk to Craig. There was an episode that we played, the beer review, quote unquote, was you guys singing In Color by Jamie Johnson.
Oh, yeah.
And I'll tell you
that
what.
That was a train wreck.
No, it was not a train wreck.
We weren't singing it. We were crying.
It was, yeah. It
there was
very
cats
emotional.
Meowing it.
It was beautiful. And I got so much feedback. In fact, if you go look, at, I believe it's the top comment on Apple Podcasts right now. Is somebody saying that they loved your guys' rendition of In Color.
Okay, you can open your eyes.
Okay, so my eyes are
there
open.
There was a lot of emotion to it.
This is. I thought this was you.
He oh, that is me. You. I'm sorry. Yeah.
All right, go to work, Blathifer.
Clear your palate.
Okay. My palate's clear. I just had a Miller Lite.
Oh, I know what this is.
Oh. Okay, I don't know what it is, but I can tell you what's in it.
Dead giveaway.
Well, that's part of the bet.
This is a lemon Hefeweizen.
Okay.
It's a Hefeweizen with lemon in it.
You got to drink it.
That is based purely off of the way it looks and smells.
It might be
Coors
original with a squirt of lemon.
Might be
in
a summer summer fest.
Well, I'll do what I initially intended for Jersey and Tim to do when I asked them to review beers. the appearance
not
is
cursed.
Quite hazy. It's very. I don't care a shit about it. So the appearance is very pale straw and it's very very hazy. Decent cap of very white foam on the top, and the nose is incredibly lemony. Lemon, like Lemon Pledge.
Okay.
Lemon Pledge.
So that's an American wheat ale. That is not a Hefeweizen. That is an American wheat ale because I don't get any phenolics or esters.
We don't even.
Yeah.
He's reading the bottle right now.
Like a little thing to write down what he says.
And I'll tell
so
you
he
what.
He can't change his mind later.
So I do get there's a certain character that I get from New Belgium beers, who make Fat Tire. It's a biscuity thing, and I do get
I
a hint.
Biscuits.
I do get Well, you should drink Fat Tire. In fact, Jersey will not drink Fat Tire anymore because of the.
You said it tastes like biscuits, and now all I can taste is biscuits, and I hate it.
Yeah,
I used
to
love it. It used to be one of.
It is a hard beer to drink. I'll be honest, but so my guess on this one, because I'm not. I don't want to spend too much time because I feel like you got to go with your gut, right? So my guess on this one is that it's some, I've never heard of it, but it's got to be some form of a lemon dosed American wheat ale or like American Hefeweizen that, and I, just because
lemon
of the.
Lemon dosed American Hefeweizen.
Hefeweizen or wheat ale, same thing.
I don't know.
And I'm going to guess the brewery is New Belgium.
Is what?
New
American,
Belgium.
Hang on.
They
American
make Fat Tire.
Wheat ale. And you're guessing New Belgium.
It's it tastes very much like a those.
Okay. So
those
you're
lemon...
wrong on the brewery,
Timmy. What do you think about this?
Oh,
it's not bad.
Okay, that's not too. I wasn't too far
you're
off.
Wrong on the brewery, but I think you're right on everything else. I don't know what type of beer.
Well, so it's a Line and Kugels. Shandy is a beer with lemonade.
This I
is
didn't like
a
the first
Weiss,
taste, but the
Weiss
more you drink
beer,
it,
that's a wheat
is.
Beer.
Yeah.
Weiss beer brewed with honey and natural lemon flavor.
Would you say
good,
that
actually.
I nailed it?
I think you got that one. Yeah,
okay.
I'll give you that.
But I've never had a Line and Kugels beer in my entire life.
So a Weiss beer is a wheat ale.
Yeah, it's okay. Weiss beer is like a white beer, a wheat ale, yeah. But I'll tell you what, this is not if when I've seen this on the shelves, I've been very trepidatious. Justin's here. Yay!
Hey.
To try it, I never would have expected. I believe big it's
dude, this is one of my favorite. So, short story, when we were in Montana for a year, I was in charge of filling the bar with beer, and these are all like burly American Montana men, and they're like, "We want Budweiser and Coors Light, like that
right,
kind of man.
Right, right.
And I started putting Summer Shandy in there, and they were loving it. Like that keg was emptying before all the other ones. And when
they
found out what it
together.
Was, they were like, damn it, we're not drinking that. But it's really good.
So it is far better than I expected.
It's good, dude.
Based on what I've seen, I see it on the shelves, yeah.
I think the kids could sell
my,
this on the
corner my faves,
during
dog.
The summer.
Totally. Are you drinking some too, Craig? What do you think?
I like this morning other than the Bud Light.
I know. We had Tim and I started off our morning with Bud Light.
Timmy, your turn, bud.
You guys don't want to review it? What do you think, Tim?
I love it. It's delicious.
I think it's very refreshing. I didn't like the first sip of it, but the more I drink, it's very
it's
refreshing.
Super refreshing.
The first sip was real lemony, which was what's good.
It's almost like Lemon Pledge, and like the very strong lemon.
Well,
lemon
I'm very
pledge.
Clean right now.
Hello, Dustin.
Hello.
You and Craig have to steal. So Patton Oswalt just showed up. Justin, you and Craig have to share a mic.
Ebony
only have four.
Ivory.
Say anything. I will not. These are secrets.
All right,
we pick one of
Timmy's
next, huh?
Do it. All right, I'll finish this.
Which one do you want there, Timmy Tim? Don't say it.
We're going to do one more, then we got to take a break because I got to pee.
Well, you need to put blinders on. Like, turn around or something.
I'm not going to look, I promise.
You are going to look.
Here's the problem is that while you guys are doing this, I'm not a big fan of dead air, and I don't want to edit this show because I've got so much going on lately. My eyes are closed.
Close your eyes. She's going to show it to the camera.
Patton, why don't you get on and talk to us about how things have been going? I can't see anything, Jers. I promise you. I want Patton Oswalt to come say a couple of words. You got to share a
bottle opener.
Everybody, this is Patton Oswalt. I'm coming to you in the cool.
You
cool
sound like you're
in.
There you go. Yeah.
I'm sorry.
How have you been, Justin?
I've been wonderful, Marshall. just on the comedy tour, doing those types of things. Just trying to become a learned man. I'm already in strike two.
I told you this before, but we're going to pretend like this is the first time I'm telling you. One of the comments that we got after our Kick in the Kegs episode that you were here for was that we should integrate sort of like a Jersey and Tim beer review, but with Patton Oswalt doing food reviews. So like food pairing with food pairings.
Oh, this one's good,
like
Marshall.
That's an absolute wise idea. I think that your ratings will go through the roof, and your listeners will jump from 2 to 2.5.
How do you get a half listener?
Yeah,
I think that's the next episode.
It's averages. It's averages, Jersey.
Kicking the kegs. This food is going to be involved.
Well, so I originally planned. I'll be honest. I originally planned on this episode being a kick in the kegs, but I kicked all my kegs by myself. There, I literally have two beers on tap right now.
Problem.
We should have done a you know, like a Via Las Vegas episode.
Yeah, you got to be in front of the mic if you want.
All right,
to hear
Mr. Shell, offering number two.
All right, beer number two. Here we go. This we're gonna take a
just
break.
Just like high school.
This,
so.
You all have one.
Oh, just
one.
Yes.
Oh, that's
you. Come on.
Are you reading the comments?
Oh, that's amazing.
What are they saying?
Oh.
Marshall sucks.
Crispy.
What does it say? Oh, God. I'll read some. When we come back, we'll start off with some questions. There's a few in there now.
That's yummy.
That sure does smell good.
It sure does smell good.
Crisp.
That was
my word.
Why don't you snip
it
some more, you nerd?
That's.
Go with the guess.
I do want to go with my gut, and I think I know it. Okay.
One more, smell it, one more drink, and then you tell us what it is.
Yeah, maybe sniff it some more.
Coors Banquet.
Coors Banquet is the guess. What's the type? What type of beer is Coors? A Pilsner.
Well, this would be. I'm not. I don't think it's a light American light ale or American light lager. I think it's a premium American
so
premium.
You know
is
how
style.
When we do beer reviews, we're just like, I think it tastes like this. When he does beer reviews, he's got to show his knowledge.
Don't you dare.
Who wants to be a millionaire? When they're like, well, my dad, you know, when I grew up, my dad was a real huge fan of Teddy Roosevelt. So I want to say Teddy Roosevelt, but I also know that he was a Rough Rider in 1852, so he wouldn't have applied.
Oh God!
Look all how right, knowledgeable. Well, even if I get it wrong, you know how knowledgeable I am.
Do we do four questions or four answers, and then he can phone a friend and ask?
No, yeah, I don't need a phone friend.
There's stakes on the line.
Yeah, I don't have a phone. We ran out of those.
We don't
phones.
Fuck around when there's beef on
there's
the line.
There's beef on the line here. Yeah, I'm going to go with Coors Banquet, which is an American, you know, lager.
Pilsner, my friend, are you ready?
Oh, I do love me some Sapporo.
We just drank this in Vegas.
So that's a... I know we did.
That was the two
what
for...
What type of beer is Sapporo?
And a shot.
I know.
Remember.
So we're drinking Sapporo, which is a Japanese... It's a premium lager.
What's in it? It's government warning is what's in it. It's a product of Vietnam.
Oh, really?
That's what it says on here. But it is Japanese beer. That's weird.
Hmm. I really do love Sapporo.
So what type
and
of
makes
beer
me want to
Sapporo?
Have sushi. It's a premium lager. It's a like
so
a
so you got the
lager.
Type right.
Sure. Yeah.
Did
had
you
we
though? Thrown out a couple sushi rolls
did
in front
you
of you,
I feel like that one was
nailed
way
it.
American.
Honestly, if you
a little
if you,
bit of salmon, a little bit of sake, and then a whole lot of Sapporo.
I think that one was a miss.
Call it a miss. That's fine.
I don't know. Let's see what your audience thinks.
Well, let's poll them. If before we take a break
all
here,
four of them.
All four of them? I don't know. Well, there's nine in there now.
Oh, okay,
so,
I'm sorry.
Yeah,
but
see, Patton brings you through the roof.
That is such a good beer, though.
It is a great beer.
It's really good. Well,
everybody hands a glass.
No one is chiming in yet because there is about a 45-second delay.
I am really craving some fried rice with bacon right now and shrimp and New York steak with hot and spicy sauce.
Where's that from?
Curachaya, right here on First and Knees.
I love
Which
it, dude.
Which is Japanese for cherry blossom, in case you're
Is that
wondering.
What that means?
That is exactly
They do
what
have
that
the
means.
Cherry blossom flowers
they
on
They do.
It. All right, we've got to go grab some more beers because we want to keep doing this fun thing. So hang tight. We'll be right back after these messages. So I've been hanging out with brewers and craft beer nerds for a long time now, and while we do occasionally have our differences, one thing it seems we all share is a love of learning and trying new things, as well as saving a couple of bucks. Well, right now, Craft Beer and Brewing is helping fans of Brewlosophy learn more while saving some coin by offering 20% off the price of a subscription to their awesome magazine. Chock full of brewing insights, tips, and recipes from industry experts, Craft Beer and Brewing is seriously great. I read every issue page to page myself. To get 20% off your subscription, all you have to do is sign up at beerandbrewing.com/brewlosophy. Want to brew quality craft beer at home? The Grainfather provides a brewing system with superior design, innovative features, and the latest technology, allowing you to brew professional quality craft beer at home. Mash, sparge, boil, and cool all in one unit, meaning there's less equipment to use, clean, and store. No need for burners or hot plates. Just plug it in and brew great beer. Then get the best out of your fermentation with the Grainfather Conical Fermenters and Glycol Chiller. Plus, enhance your brewing experience with the brand new free-to-use Grainfather Community app. You can take your brewing tools and your recipes with you everywhere, use brewing calculators on the fly, manage your recipes, and monitor your brew session from anywhere. Use your mobile device to manage your Grainfather brew wirelessly, automate mash schedules, and multitask without removing any of the brewing hands-on fun. Grainfather products can all be found at www.grainfather.com. Plus, as a Brewlosophy podcast listener, get 10% off your order. Just use discount code BRULOSOPHY19 at checkout. That's BRULOSOPHY19 to receive 10% off your order. So head to shop.grainfather.com now to get this great deal. After a long brew day, the last thing I want to do is waste more time chilling wort. I've tried so many different options, and ultimately I settled on the super efficient immersion chillers made by Jaded Brewing. With the King Cobra and Hydra, I'm able to chill my entire batch of wort, from boiling to just a few degrees above groundwater temperature, in as little as 6 minutes. If an immersion chiller is right for your brewery, then do yourself a favor and check out all of the rad options Jaded Brewing has to offer at jadedbrewing.com. And be sure to let them know Brewlosophy sent you. All right, our bladders are empty. We've got a full ice chest of beer. We're going to get back to some reviews in a minute. But first, there are some questions coming in. I figured we'd start this one off with the first question from Ryan Hansen. He's actually a local Fresnan here who brews. He's brewed with Snatch, another fighter pilot or ex-fighter pilot. So Ryan Hansen says, first question, is it true that if you don't use it, you lose it?
Is that a serious question? That's from 40-year-old Virgin when he takes her daughter to like the sex therapy thing. But he's the one that asked all the questions. Yeah. And he's like, I have a question. Is it true if you don't use it, you lose it? And the therapist is like, is that a serious question?
So that's the answer then. Are you going to pour that's us beer? Because awesome. We've... pour us the next beer. I won't look. My eyes are closed.
Pour me something tall and strong. Yeah, no. Close. Dude, if you...
Eyes closed.
If
it's
you
very
open
difficult.
Your eyes when they're supposed to be closed again, then no. You're buying everyone in this room a steak.
I'm going to poke them.
All right. Somebody else has got to talk then, because I rely on what you guys look like to say stuff.
Let's just have Patton Oswalt
right
sing
in front of you.
Yeah. Just, yeah. What's the song that Patton Oswalt does so well?
Is my horse.
Gonna take my horse to the whole town road. Jersey's gonna pour like he don't no more. He's pouring a cold beer, gonna pass it around, gonna sip it down, oh, downtown. Marshall's
oh
got a
God.
Hat full of Yakima Valley hops.
Speaking of Yakima Valley hops.
Wait, you didn't do the, can't nobody tell me nothing. That's my favorite part.
That song is so bad.
We had to take a break because Marshall had a lean up in his bladder.
Okay. All right.
Oh, my God.
Caveat. If he guesses this one correctly, instant winner.
Can I open my eyes yet?
Oh.
Yes, you can open your eyes.
That's a lot on the table.
Instant winner if you nail the exact... It has to be the exact beer that this is.
And the brewery?
Everything exact. It has to be it.
Oh, this... I know. This is my impression of Jersey and Tim. I'm going to be both of you. Watch.
He's going to do both of us.
Ooh.
Both of us?
Watch. Ooh. Barley wine. That's not a fucking barley wine. Come on. Come on, man. We've been doing this too long. Everything's either a barley wine or a pill.
What do you need us for?
What? I learned that from you. I learned that. And then Jersey will sing something.
It's not a barley wine. You didn't say curse.
It does smell like a barley wine. I'll tell you that. Let me taste it first, though.
It's amazing.
Oh, God, it went up my nose.
It has been a minute since I've had one.
Oh, does it have a good nose feel?
It's got great nose feel, yeah. Let's give her a taste. Ooh. That's not a barley wine. That is a...
is that your guess? Not a barley wine?
Yeah. Does that win me steak?
Now you do sound like us.
Ooh, it's kind of a... There's like an herbal grassy thing in the finish. So I get a
here it goes.
Oh, this smells like DBA, like Firestone Walker DBA. That's what I get from it.
That's a good guess. Yeah.
Good guess.
That's a good guess, but
I didn't know what the fuck I was doing.
Can you...
I can say you've definitely had it before.
Not saying that that's not it, but that's what I'd guess. But I didn't know what the fuck was going on.
Hold on.
This is an instant winner if you nail this.
I know. I want to nail it, dude. I just want
to
win.
You don't have to take 7 minutes and tell five stories.
Can I hear your guys' review of it without knowing what it is?
Tastes a lot like Kool-Aid. Oh, you want an expert opinion?
No, because... exactly. Tap out, amateur.
Teacher, can I use a calculator?
Put your seatbelt on. You ready?
It's
delicious. Mm. Is what it is.
There's a little like a bitter thing in the finish.
It does.
A little caramel.
I think it actually does taste like a barley wine.
It smells like a barley wine.
It's like a barley wine light.
Yeah. Hmm. Yeah.
Maybe it's a barley wine, Marshall. More, but I don't know. Good. God, you look so unlearned right now. We're just ripping apart this facade of excellence.
I have spent the last 2.5 years trying to convince you guys that I'm not this genius that you think I am.
Well, it only took 5 minutes. You did in 5 minutes what you've been trying to do for 2 years.
And 2 beers.
What a waste of time.
So one way to view that is that I finally succeeded. I win.
You're on track. You've nailed all the types. The last one I think was a push. I could call that one a loss, I think.
Yeah.
You were way off. Samsonite.
Simmy, Sammy, Swami.
Slimmy.
That was way off.
That is very familiar to me.
It should be.
I've had this before.
That you were way off of.
Time's up, dude.
All right. I give up.
You give up. You're not guessing. You have to guess.
My guess would have been DBA, but I can clearly tell that it's
please.
Not. American Amber Ale or like an English
American.
But your guess is that you already put your guess.
American.
We can't hear you. You're not talking to the mic.
Amber Ale, and your guess is a DBA.
Wouldn't it go good with like a burrito?
Okay, I'm gonna read you the type. This is
I know what it is.
According to the back, is a easy drinking Mexican style amber lager.
Dos Equis amber. Taco truck.
Damn.
And it's their amber lager.
We were just talking about it last night.
You got the American amber ale, right?
No. That's an amber lager. So this would be more like a Vienna lager.
Oh, so you missed
I missed
type?
It. Yeah, yeah.
Bam!
Is this your first time drinking beer?
I know. Taco truck comes from, in fact, Laura and I will be going there. My family will be going there for lunch on Friday in Turlock. Dust Bowl Brewing Company.
Ooh.
They're amazing.
We were just talking about it last night.
And I'll tell you what.
Their queso chips are to die for.
Their queso chips are amazing. Everything that they make is great.
You would die for their queso chips.
There's two things I'd die for. The flag and queso chips.
There you go. So a little shout out.
Like we're having a field trip to Turlock on Friday.
We're going to Turlock.
I'm not going to Turlock.
I pull that back. I don't
want
to be Manchestered. I don't want to actually die.
There's a felony clause to the Manchester. I believe killing yourself might be a felony. I don't know.
It is illegal, apparently. But to give Dust Bowl some credit, we don't ever talk. They're a local Central Valley brewery who we very rarely talk about. But they make incredible beer. They do a really great job.
So I can wash it down with some.
They just opened up a spot in Monterey as well.
Dust Bowl did, huh? Nice. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, I know they have two spots in Turlock now. So if you're driving through the Central Valley on 99, not I-5, you can stop off at a couple spots in Turlock and get Dust Bowl. That beer is fantastic. It was a little bit. I got more of a fruity hop thing from it. That's why I said it was an ale.
It was good.
Good pick, Timmy.
Yeah,
it was good.
But that one. But also that beer is delicious. I would drink that all day. It wasn't. Yeah. So all right, next beer. Let's move on.
Close your eyes.
Give me a beer.
Can't you feel my mouth drooling? Do you understand?
Well, can I have one eye open and look this way? Maybe
you can open your eyes. You can open your eyes. Just don't look under the table.
Close your eyes.
I'll just Tim and I. Let's
you
sing
can open
each other.
Your eyes.
Yeah.
Lock eyes.
You know the words to In Color.
We're not gonna sing that right now. No one wants to.
That was a one-time deal, bro.
We've done that a million times.
Not a million.
I just happened to make.
Hey,
I just happened to put it on the show.
Literally, is the only one that has to drink beers to make this work. Could you finish your beer?
But I'll tell you, that Miller Lite's really good.
The Miller Lite is the best beer I've had yet so far.
They know what they're doing.
To cleanse the glasses, and it's better than anything we've had.
Can you just give me more of that? Yeah.
No, you're going to like this one, buddy.
We've also been drinking
this,
it all
Marshall,
morning.
Yeah, we this have is been. An, we started
this
early.
Is another.
Can I look now?
Yeah, you can look. Right. You can look whenever you want.
All right.
I'm having Michelle show them to the camera. Whoa. So you can't look for that. But after
that's
that,
why she keeps moving. That's right. I get it.
It's blocked here, though.
I'm not looking.
Yeah,
at the
I just
camera.
Don't want you to. Oh fuck!
No! You can't see.
No, it's blocked.
You can't see it.
Okay. So this is another instant winner. You'll get the type immediately.
Okay.
Probably by looking at it. But if you guess the brand of this beer, this is an instant winner.
All it needs the brand.
No. The specific brand and type. So like if Budweiser made a, you know, like this is a Budweiser or whatever. You know what I mean?
But I don't have to have the name of the beer style or the beer that that's actually made.
Like if you walked up to a bar and ordered it. You have to be able to walk up to the bar and order the specific type.
So okay. Like
you can't just say Firestone Walker. You got to say Firestone Walker DBA.
But what if I said, for example, I want the taco truck that's like a Vienna lager.
Close enough.
Okay, close enough.
Put it up to the chair.
I could go for two carne asada tacos. All right.
Cheers, gents.
Oh, that's an IPA.
Well, I told you. I mean,
that's hands down.
I mean, even I know what an IPA is.
That's definitely juniper.
Oh, God.
I smell juniper. Yeah.
Do you smell Learned Men, Jersey? Because that's...
Dude, I love IPAs, man.
How do you distinguish these juniper beers?
You know what I can distinguish? When you talk into the side of the mic as opposed to when you talk into the front of the mic.
How is this?
You're a communications format bully.
You just can't hear him, which is...
Well, if you would invest in an extra microphone for the five some days, this wouldn't be an issue.
Well, right. I was hoping one of you wouldn't show up today. That was the...
Wow.
Take a swing.
Bye, Justin.
I was here first. Get out,
Go
Justin.
Burn some tri-tip.
I got tri-tip.
Chew all right, tri-tip. So this actually tastes quite familiar.
It's delicious.
So what it tastes like... There's a cleanness and
God, I gotta go clean my cupboards.
You don't like it, Jersey?
So good. This is such a good. I know IPA is not your thing, dude, but this is a really good IPA.
All right, so it reminds you. I'm not saying that. I'm not making a call. It reminds me of an IPA I had when I was at Maui Brewing Company in Maui last year in July.
Here we go with the I wonder who wants to be a millionaire shit again.
I know. Well, what else? You're asking me to do this. I don't know any other way to do this. We got to kill time. So
no, I do like that hearing your. I like hearing your thought process because I too desire to be a learned man.
This is a classic West Coast.
So good.
Piney. It's so good. This is so really good IPA, and it's not old. You can tell it's fairly fresh.
Okay, so go with your gut.
I would say this is not that bad for an IPA.
It's a delicious IPA.
It's not that good.
Just because you don't like IPAs, bro.
I'm with you. You know, I'm with you, Timmy. I don't like IPAs either, but that's not bad.
I'll tell you what. He's had, last night even, when we were swimming in my pool, you drank in a Easy Jack, Firestone Walker Easy
that was
Jack.
Good.
That's one of the few that he's been, now that's a session IPA.
Is it Easy Jack or Union Jack?
Easy Jack is the lower alcohol version. Union Jack's the regular IPA.
I'm just gonna
go with Maui Brewing Company IPA.
Okay, what you have to give me the name.
I don't know it. That's what I was trying to tell you. Holy shit!
Whoa!
Damn! Wow.
Big Swell's their classic IPA.
Yeah, but you needed to get Big Swell for an instant win. But that is impressive.
Oh my God!
That was good.
Now, okay,
that's impressive.
So can I talk about how I was able to do that? So. When
it's
I was
a great beer.
I don't drink much IPA when I go out. I'll get craft lagers. If they don't have a good one, I'll get a Miller Lite, right? When I was in Maui last year, I went to I met up with a buddy of mine, Ben, who is a Brewlosophy fan. He has been for a long time. Really great guy. Ben, we love you, buddy, if you're out there. And I think both of us brought a whole bunch of Cody's crawling through the maze in here. We both brought a whole bunch of Maui Brewing Company cans out to the beach, and we were hanging out at a Black Rock on Ka'anapali, on the Lahaina side of the island, and we just had a great time. And I remember thinking, man, I never get IPA, but this is really good. So the only IPA that I drink on the regular is Union Jack. This doesn't taste like Union Jack.
That's still good,
but it's very, very clean. And I remember thinking, God, they are killing it because it's so crisp and clean.
The last time I was in Hawaii,
I feel like I should win this one.
The last time I was in Hawaii, I was on the beach and I posted a picture of just me holding this beer out of the water, and you were like, oh my God, I love that fucking Big Swell Maui Brewing IPA. So I knew
that
you might make a connection. No, you it's one of your three. Remember I said if you nail three?
Okay, that's
one of your three, but it's not an instant win.
All right, cool.
So you got one instant win down, or one of your three. You just need to get another one, and then when that's left, you just need to get one more.
One more.
And then you're gonna win.
Oh, number one.
That was impressive.
Okay. That was impressive.
That was good. That was very, very good.
He got the Maui Brewing Company. He just didn't know the name of their IPA.
I didn't know it was called Big Swell.
I honestly feel Big like Swell. We should have given him that one, but
no,
we can't.
No.
He gets it as
based on how you look with your shirt off, it should be Big Swole.
Big Swole, that's right. Well, that was Vegas. That was freshly lubed. So Tim, you and I get to talk again, so I don't look at the.
Okay, don't look.
Don't look. Can't look at the beer.
It is funny that Jersey, after knowing me for as long as he has, thinks that I would want to cheat on this. I have zero interest in cheating on this. I'm happy to buy you both steak. I don't give a shit. Yeah.
Done.
Stop looking.
Hey, you know what I'll do? I have a great idea. I'll let everybody know what's coming up. We've got some cool events coming up.
Can I have your glass,
up.
Marshall?
Yes, you can. We've got some cool events coming up. I will be, let's see, in coming up in October, I will be heading to Dublin, Ireland for the BrewCon. I wish you were going too, Timmy.
I wish I was going.
I wish everyone was going. But we will be there for the 2019 BrewCon. It happens on October 5th. That's October 5th Irish time, right? We got it because I know that's a little different. 9 hours ahead of us, all that stuff. We will be there. If you are in the UK or in Scotland or if you're in Ireland, please make it a point to come down. We'd love to hang out with you. There's going to be some other great speakers there as well. I know that Ron Pattinson from Shut Up About Barkley Perkins will be a guest as well. It's going to be a great time. And then in September, so about a month after we get back from Ireland, I will be heading up to Yakima, Washington to hang out with our friends from Yakima Valley Hops. And here's the cool thing. Brian usually does go down there with me. That's a thing that Brian and I typically do. We've been doing it for the last 3 or 4 years. I believe Jake is going to be meeting us up in Yakima as well. So there will be 3 Brewlosophy guys hanging out with about 15 Yakima Valley Hops guys. We will not be able to make it. Unfortunately, we won't be able to make it for the they're amazing. The Fresh Hop Party. There we go. Yeah, it is. Well, you don't
know. Ain't no party like a Fresh Hop Party.
Yeah, that's right. The Fresh Hop Party.
Did you just
party.
Invite Timmy to something that I'm not invited to?
No, you're both invited. You said you might try to make it, actually.
I don't know what's happening in October. I think I'm going somewhere.
Oh my God, we're watching the planning in action. Here we go.
Go to Ukraine or something. I can't remember.
Yeah, you'll be in Ukraine.
You ready?
We've already talked about this. Yeah. So anyways, that's that. And then I just want to let everyone know, I forget the exact dates, but Matt Del Fiocco will be going back to the...
Matt Del Fiocco.
He will be presenting at the... There's a homebrew, like a homebrew fest type of thing that they put that Atlantic Brew Supply over in North Carolina puts on. They're going to be doing that. And so I forget the exact dates. I don't have it in front of me. We're trying to... filled dead air here, but Google it. Matt will be there. He'll be giving a talk. All right, let's get back to drinking some booze.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is the shit. This is a good beer.
Yeah, it smells good.
Yeah, it smells delicious. All right, let's let him just go with this. This is one of mine. It's one of my favorite picks.
I mean, I feel like you guys are trying to fool me.
No.
Fool me once. Can't get fooled again.
Yeah. I've actually never had one of these, and this is delicious.
He's gonna get it. He's gonna whiff on this.
That's good.
You know what it tastes like is a malt liquor.
He's gonna whiff on this one. Keep going. Keep digging yourself into a hole, there, guy.
Oh God.
You guys, you realize that I'm paying attention to every
That's
little
smooth.
Thing.
Yeah. What you're paying attention to That's is when good. I take him in and out of the cooler. You cheating motherfucker.
Right.
We don't care if our kids hear swear words. If you are one of those people who do,
I forgot we were live. I'm sorry.
No, it doesn't matter.
Also, I'm a fighter pilot. That's just how we talk.
That's your cheating motherfucker.
See how my checking account is set up. See the way my bank account is set up.
Remember when you were in like elementary choir and they would make you do rounds? We should
That's
all do
good,
a round
Jersey.
Of fuck.
Can you?
You are rushing me, and I'm trying to let it sink in.
It doesn't take that long. It doesn't take that. Doesn't take. Doesn't take Timmy and I this long.
Thank you, Michelle. Thank you, Michelle. God, yeah, you understand.
He doesn't know. His bill is mine.
Dad, I believe in him.
I do feel like it's a something that I've had before.
Wow. This guy's incredible.
In other words,
he's amazing. He's amazing.
This guy is incredible. Have you ever seen this kind of deduction power?
It's amazing.
Just unraveling his dynasty.
Just
unraveling his.
You know what it reminds me of? So this morning, Tim and I were drinking Bud Light in his garage.
Yeah.
Because some dumbass brought Bud Light to his. Little does he know that we are learned men who actually like Miller Lite. It has that.
He doesn't even know his buddies.
Well, I know that Abraham Lincoln was the 42nd president.
You
and
are
I know that
asking
the 44th
me.
President was
oh
right
my God.
After.
Anyway, we were drinking the Bud Light.
Keep going. Come on. We love you.
We're done, guys. I don't want to do this anymore. Just kidding.
I thought you were serious.
It got real in a hurry.
Holy shit.
Motherfucker.
I just got a panic attack. I thought he was serious.
Would I ever be serious
you
about
heard
that?
Him pucker have you ever?
Have you ever? Have I ever been?
No, which is why it scared me so much.
Oh, my God.
Hey, man, I got feelings, too.
Oh, Jesus.
I hate it when mommy and daddy fight.
It does smell like a malt, like a malt liquor, like Mickey's or something. Mickey's or like 8-Ball.
8-Ball?
Old English 800. Oh. Something like that. I'm just going to go malt liquor. I don't know whose it is.
Time for a guess, buddy. You're guessing malt liquor.
Old English.
O-E. The 8-Ball.
Mickey's.
And from the 8-Ball, my breath starts stinking.
No, I'm going Mickey's instead because I've had it.
Mickey's.
Boom! I told you it tastes like a malt liquor.
I did not think you would guess that.
That's actually really good.
That's two.
Marshall's inner OG.
That's two. One more.
That is really good.
We should have. We should have got Tim. Timmy, we should have got some Steel Reserve.
Oh.
Nobody likes Mickey's. That was a joke.
We should have went to Pinedale Liquor.
I was looking for some Snake Eyes.
Well, I'll tell you what.
Did you get this from Ronnie's Midway Market?
So, I know you guys may not want to hear it, but this is a show that we need to create, you know, stuff for. So I'll tell you a story about Mickey's that I've got.
Tell me.
So I told a little story about how I, I was in high school and first time I ever got drunk was off of Bud Ice and all this stuff. This was in the last episode or the Bruise Views episode.
That's cute, Bud Ice.
Bud Ice was terrible.
Ooh, I like Bud Ice.
No, I did too.
So hear me out. So then. I found religion for a while, and then after that while, I decided to leave that. I lost it. Yeah, I tell people
losing
I abandoned it.
Losing my religion.
That's right. Yeah, yeah. REM is gonna we're gonna have to pay them now to fucking. So anyways, so I move
give
in.
My Mickey's.
We leave this school in Idaho. Laura and I do, and we left with. I was in a band, and most of the bandmates came out, and we moved into a house together. And so in our first night, so Laura's still down in Seattle. I'm up in Bellingham in Western Washington University. And the first night, we're both still 18, 19 years old, me and my roommate. And he brings home his laundry that he had washed at the laundromat, right? On the top are two 40s of Mickey's.
No, but you weren't 21, dude.
No, I don't know how he got them. I have, till this day, I have
but
no
you weren't 21. You can't drink if you're not 21.
So anyways, so I end up crushing.
I'm sorry I'm hung up on this. Does everybody else break the law? Jesus. What's next?
Hey, 9, you're fine. 10, you're mine, right? That's so anyways, I drink the whole.
Damn.
It's that's speeding. That's speeding. That's a speeding rule. Yeah. Excuse me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What other?
Wow. Thanks for clearing that up.
Hold on. I think the guy that.
Keep drinking, Epstein.
The reporter from. The reporter from To Catch a Predator just showed up. 1 second, everybody.
What are you doing here? Being an idiot, I guess.
I was just trying to teach a lesson.
All right, so to finish the story, in the 15 minutes that it took for him to drop his girlfriend off and come back home, I had crushed that whole 40 of Mickey's. And when he walked in, I was just over the toilet for probably a good 2 hours that
pooping?
Night.
Yeah. Were you pooping?
No, I was not.
I mean, you already broke the law, so you might as well.
Yeah, I was repenting. I was repenting. That's what I was doing. I was repenting. Yeah. All right, pour another beer. I'm turning. I'm going to talk. I'm going to talk to you,
Marshall. Just a quick story on the 40s. That was our deal. When we turned 40, we had to drink 40s, and we bought them from the nastiest places.
Don't look, dude.
And one of my
I'll do it. I don't give a shit.
Bad ones called Steel Reserve.
Oh, it's terrible. It's terrible.
Horrible. Steel Reserve glows in the dark.
Yeah. It's terrible. It's terrible. It's terrible. I've had it.
Tall and strong.
So I originally thought Mickey's. I went Old English.
Ooh, Timmy, good pick.
Because it did taste like malt liquor. That was the one thing I nailed right off the bat.
That was good.
Okay, so I'm going to do something different where I'm going to hand this to you so you can start doing it while I pour everybody else.
Oh, damn. We are taking a divergence from the pale lager category, apparently.
We jump straight to chocolate milk, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah. If you serve it to him, he'd tell a story about how one time when he was a kid, he had chocolate milk.
That's what this show is.
Well, it's funny you should mention that. I visited a dairy one time.
You know what? You know what? Fuck you, Jersey, for one. And here's the thing. If this show was ever, you know what? This show would be 10 minutes if it was the way you planned it. I just fucking pick the beer and move on.
That's what everyone else hopes.
I feel. Oh, sorry.
That'd be really fun. A 15-minute show of you guys saying stupid shit. And
Jersey, we got an empty glass right
well,
there.
I'm not going to waste. No, we got extra.
Give me so much of this crap.
Holy cow.
Wow.
Brewing company, please.
Bring forth the steak.
Oh, that's good.
That's it's actually not good. Bad.
It's really good.
I picked a good one.
No, this is delicious. Is this your pick?
This is good stuff.
Well, there's 12 of us. So.
I do.
I smell coffee.
Here, cheers to that.
Yeah.
You don't want an IPA, but you'll drink that.
This is good.
This is incredible, dude.
This is no, really good. Yeah.
This is no... really...
All right, Mr. Wow. Shell.
I love it.
Let's take a look at
what
it is.
I don't even know
what
I picked, but this is definitely cocoa. A little coffee
yeah,
going.
But see, here's the thing. So when you guys... when I serve you guys these... these like stouts
got,
and stuff.
Coffee.
Hey, all these people in the background.
Well, he's gonna guess the style.
It's a stout, yeah. But could you, be, when you guys do reviews,
could be a porter.
You. Could be, oh my god, what? That was a recent one, the Raisinette one. That's what it was, the Raisinette porter. Yeah. But
I
when
do
you guys
a little
do
bit of raisin in
when
it.
You usually when you so stout, you can kind of smell coffee and chocolate even without the addition of those. But you'd usually nail it when there's actually coffee or chocolate in there. So hearing you say that you get kind of a coffee chocolate thing. Mm-hmm.
You're not going to guess.
You know what?
I get cocoa. I get like Hershey's
you,
cocoa.
You've already correctly guessed the type.
Oh, I know it's a stout. Yeah.
So I'll read you the back of it. And then
like
you,
a, no, you don't have to do that.
Like, yeah, if Laura was baking some cookies right now, that would be amazing.
He's not going to guess the
I don't believe I've ever heard of the.
Marshall, this really hearty good. Stout is layered with flavors of roasted barley, chocolate, and coffee coming from the highest quality imported Ooh. Malts. Its creamy, long-lasting head completes the brew, tempting your taste buds to be spellbound. I'll even go a little further and say this is brewed in California, IA.
Spellbound.
Make your guess, good sir.
Wow.
I really like this.
Uh-huh. It's really good.
What do you think, Jordan?
I think it's delicious, dude. It's a great pick, Timmy. Nice. You stuck it, dude.
Is
stuck
it Imperial? It's not a fucking Imperial. Shut up, Timmy.
You don't even know what Imperial means.
You don't even know what
Imperial
means.
What does Imperial mean?
He's like, I don't know. I just snorted, didn't I?
Is that margarine?
You trying
to code it?
Yeah. Good.
Yep.
Yeah, that's good. Breakfast beer.
This is delicious, yeah.
It's very good, yeah.
Justin, what's wrong with you?
I cannot stand that beer.
No, it's okay. Preferences
but Timmy likes it.
You know
he really likes it.
Let him do 100 episodes of tasting beers, and he'll realize that that's a good beer.
Well, yeah. he
right.
won't do...
Fucking
he,
uncouth, unlearned man.
I'm more of a rosé all day type of a guy.
Dude, Michelle, when Michelle got back, that's Tim's wife is Michelle. She went out this morning and had a whole bunch of mimosas. That made me, my mouth water. I love mimosas so much, too.
Could you, oh, girl. Could you stick to the beer? So good.
Do the beer. Do the beer. We're not going to feed you
I don't, mimosa. Actually, I can't tell you what.
I can't tell you what.
It's really good, though.
It's delicious.
Yeah.
You already stuck to style, so it doesn't really matter.
Oh, you know what? I'll guess it. Let's go Firestone Walker.
Wrong. Already wrong.
All right.
But that would have been a good test.
Left Coast Brewing Voodoo American Stout. So I've never had this.
The Voodoo.
It is incredibly delicious.
It's very good. Yeah. Kudos to Left Coast.
That was a good pick, Timothy.
Great pick, Timothy.
Full body. Oh, you already read this. Yeah. It's very good. 37.8 IBU. Let's see what the ABV on this. So American Stout is usually a little bit higher, quite a bit higher in alcohol than, say, like an Irish Stout.
I like you telling stories about when you're 18 because you're drinking like you're 18. Could you finish that beer, please, so I can wash it out?
8%. 8% to me.
Marshall,
you're not going to influence me.
You're not going to influence me. No.
How to avoid peer pressure. Okay?
You know what I learned, Marshall? Look at the lace on that. Right?
That's called lacing. Yeah. That's good job, lacing. Craig.
Damn, Craig.
Oh, God.
Now if you can learn how to talk into a microphone.
You're a communications bully, dude. Here, Miller Lite your shit. You ready for the next?
I'm ready for the next.
Moving on. Is the Marshall guessing train chugging right along?
So we'll do one more beer. We got to take another break.
One more beer, then we'll take another break.
Yeah, one more beer, we'll take another break.
Close your
eyes. I'm getting a little buzz. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Close your eyes. We're going to drink a beer. It's going to be super fucking tasty.
Close your eyes. Drink your beer.
Ooh, I like that version.
And guess the porter style.
He's looking right at it.
I did not see it. I promise you, I did not see it. I could not. I could not take my eyes off of Justin.
Can't take my eyes off this beer.
Yeah. Hey, do you remember talking about? I wonder how many of our listeners are of our same generation who watched the movie Rookie of the Year. Have you seen
it? The kid gets surgery and then can like pitch 120 miles.
That's
fastballs?
Right. No, that's
I
right.
Seen that.
And no. It's so
I'm
funny because
generation.
That movie was so
you're
weak.
Little old. We should talk about that. We should talk
that
about
that movie. About two weird. Generations ahead of us.
Mr. Shell.
Come on,
Mr. Shell.
Okay, one.
That movie was funny as shit.
That movie was weak.
That movie was funny as shit.
Dude, even as a kid, I hated it.
Whatever. You're dumb.
You know what? It's one of the best movies I've seen in a long time.
Ooh, that's interesting.
First Man, dude. First Man about landing on the moon. Oh, it's so good.
Okay, I'll watch it then.
And the soundtrack, I've been listening to the soundtrack to work out, and it's all...
You know what also is crazy? You guys are going to make fun of me for this, but the Greatest Showman.
That is a fantastic movie.
And also the soundtrack, I don't care what you think.
I downloaded it too.
So you and all the chicks love Greatest Showman and Titanic. You're dead to me. Can you pass me your glass, Timmy? Real man, can you pass me your glass?
I hated Titanic. I hated the Titanic. I did
hate
that
movie. I have not seen The Greatest Showman.
What? It's so good.
That's
the
because
greatest.
She didn't even try to let him on the sinking plane. Yeah, there was plenty of...
They could have let him on.
All
right, Mr. Shao. You need to stick this one. This is right in your wheelhouse.
Let it all out.
That is a Hefeweizen. I smell banana.
Bless you.
It is a Hefeweizen.
We got some nanners.
I feel like I should just quit there while I'm ahead. Thank you. Thank you. From the, what do they call that? From the peanut gallery? So that's a Hefeweizen.
So you already stuck to style. You don't have to guess the place it's coming from.
Well, no, I kind of want to. I might as well, because what if I nail it?
You know
and
what?
Then I get a free steak dinner no matter what.
It's kind of chewy.
Little bit of spice. So that's the thing with Hefeweizen, right? Is esters and phenols. Yeah, there's a chewiness to it. It's kind of thick.
Chewy.
Esters and phenols. Isn't that what Scientologists are trying to get out of me?
Ask Tom Cruise, man. I don't know.
Isn't it, dude?
That is a third level comment.
That's what they're trying to get out of you, esters and phenols. Both of those.
Oh, God. While we're thinking about this, why don't we move on to another question? Or another comment at the very least.
Like
Andrew Webster, I do not like this very much at all.
You're going to shit when you... This is a beer you've said you've liked before, so you're a liar at best. At worst, an idiot. Pick.
Liar for sure. Yeah, I lie about beer when I'm in front of the people who brewed it. So is it a Half Dome from... is it a Half Dome from Tioga Sequoia?
Is that your guess?
That's my guess.
No, it is not.
Okay.
I was going to say that if you get this wrong, I'm going to spank you.
I'm open to that.
But I thought that would be too obvious.
I got it wrong.
Come on.
You're going to spank me.
When's the last time you and I have been anywhere where one of us was getting spanked?
I've never said I like this.
You said you liked it?
No, I never said I like this. This is their Hofbräu Hefeweizen. I love Hofbräu.
We had the big glasses, and there's a lot of them.
We had their Pilsner, bro. And
you don't remember anything.
Because I would never
order them. Agree to disagree. Your word against mine.
We did both get our asses spanked.
Yes, correct, yes.
All right, so one more comment from Andrew Webster's. Jersey and Tim are certainly favorites of mine, but I also have to wonder how one of them manages to operate a multi-million-dollar jet. This is a comment that I've got
that jet
to
see,
be honest.
Multiples.
It's no problem at all.
I just get in, I put my helmet on, and I go.
I would love to answer this question.
Do it.
The American fighter pilot is basically a three-year-old child.
That's true.
It's basically a three-year-old child. Maybe like a six-year-old child.
Could a monkey do
it? One of my favorite sayings is, when your kid's like, Dad, when I grow up, I want to be a fighter pilot. The answer is, well, you can't do both. So the truth is that playing with million-dollar flying machines and hurling ourselves at each other upside down and backwards at thousands of miles an hour takes a child, man. You can't be this like, sleek, smooth, professional, but there's a couple of those in our community. But the best guys are the guys that are the most flamboyant and cocky. And
you are certainly flamboyant.
It's an aggressive... There's a quote by Robin Olds, may he rest in peace, that's like, fighter pilot's an attitude. It's aggressiveness, cockiness, flamboyance. Like, if you ever meet a guy that looks licked, you'll beat him in the air. Like, that's a mix of, like, five different pilots' quotes. But my point is, fighter pilots are maverick. They're not Iceman.
That's right. Iceman's a jerk.
He was a jerk. And he killed Goose, dude. He killed Goose.
He sort of killed Goose. We're not going to get into that argument.
He killed Goose.
He sort of
Iceman
killed
Goose.
Iceman killed Goose. And on that, we're going to go ahead and take another bathroom break. And when we come back, more beers that I'm going to try to guess.
Chilling work can be a chore, especially after a long brew day, but not with the Xchillerator Counterflow Chiller, which can chill a 5-gallon or 19-liter batch of wort in 5 minutes or less, leading to a strong cold break and clearer wort in the fermenter. Brewlosophy's Matt Del Fiocco uses the Xchillerator Max and absolutely loves it. In addition to improved chilling efficiency, every Xchillerator comes with a 5-year warranty that covers the entire chiller for manufacturer defects. If you're looking to up your chilling game and a CFC is right for you, head over to Xchillerator.com today. Family-owned Atlantic Brew Supply is the largest homebrew shop in the Southeast. No gimmicks, no multinational corporate overlords, and no BS. They offer exclusive malts, yeast, and more from local artisans, as well as award-winning recipe kits. They also sell professional brewing gear and cask equipment from sister companies ABS Commercial and Cask Supply. Most ingredients are available by the ounce, plus Atlantic Brew Supply has an on-site calculator to help you craft your best brew. Orders are processed same day, and two-day shipping is guaranteed for East Coast customers. Get 15% off your first order using promo code BrewPod. That's BRUPOD at AtlanticBrewSupply.com. When dumping wort-soaked grain and leftover low-gravity wort while cleaning up after a brew day, do you ever wonder what your true efficiency would be if that wort made its way to the kettle instead? Using the Brew Bag, a fabric filter for all mash tuns and brewing methods, allows you to capture every last drop of wort. Not only does this increase kettle efficiency, it lowers your grain bill, which saves you money. Throwing wort in the trash is like dumping a 12-pack down the drain and just doesn't make sense. Use the Brew Bag and leave no wort behind. I've been using these filters for a long time and recommend them to everyone. I never have to worry about a stuck sparge and cleanup is fast and easy. Go grab yourself a Brew Bag fabric filter at brewinabag.com and be sure to use code TBP17 at checkout to get a discount on your order. As every brewer knows, the best beer requires the best hops, which Yakima Valley Hops provides fresh from the source to brewers around the world, carrying everything from classics like Cascade to modern favorites like Galaxy and Mosaic, as well as other ingredients and gear. Yakima Valley Hops has it all. And don't forget to check out their new podcast, The Late Edition, where the YVH crew goes into depth on our favorite plant with industry experts. Head over to YakimaValleyHops.com now to see all they have to offer and subscribe to The Late Edition wherever it is you listen to podcasts. All right, we're back, ready to do some more meat. Well, I'm ready to do some more beer reviews. Tim, I think you're ready to do more.
I'm always ready.
You're ready to do some more beer drinking. But before, while Jersey is secretly pouring me this next beer, I figure what we'll do is read some more comments from our live.
Can you read it with your eyes closed?
I promise you I will look straight at this and not at you. There's no reason for me to cheat. I actually don't care if you don't pay for me for a steak. Steve Thanos, good friend of ours, he writes, congratulations on episode 100. Hey, congratulations, guys. I consider all of you a part of the Brewlosophy family. Jersey and Tim, are you guys as obsessed with Yacht Rock as Marshall?
Of course we are.
Yes.
If you had to pick a favorite Yacht Rock jam, what would it be? That's my
Ambrosia.
Question.
You're the biggest Chicago. Part of me.
That's good.
Okay, we're done. Yeah. Chicago. So Steve, that was a dumb question.
Also, should we show the album cover that we made for Yacht Rock?
Nobody should see that.
Remember the album cover?
This is a podcast, not a video, so we could. Yeah, yeah. This is a podcast.
Do you remember
though.
The album cover?
Do I remember it? I have it on my phone.
It was Orleans, dude.
Orleans.
Dance with me. Come on, to be your friend. Look away. Close your eyes.
I'm not looking. I'm looking down. I promise you. I'm not. So
look away.
What I'll do is I'll read more comments. Bob Abbott says, next break, can we get a live review of Top Gun Maverick trailer? We haven't seen that yet.
Oh, I'd love to give a live review of the Top Gun Maverick trailer.
Have you seen it? I did not see that.
I have seen the trailer.
I've not even seen the trailer.
Funny fact, multiple times. Who is this, Bob?
That's Bob Abbott, yeah.
Funny fact, Bob, is that they filmed most of it at Lemoore, which is right south of here. And I was just fighting an F-18 from Lemoore the other week, and I asked the pilot, who was a lady, I'm like, hey, did you guys get to see Tom Cruise and hang out with Tom Cruise? And she's like, no, dude. Like, they kept him away from us. Like, he would fly in the back of the jet, and they wouldn't let him mingle with the pilots. I thought that was really weird.
But they let a Hollywood star fly in the back of a jet, and they won't even let the Brulosopher go in the fucking jet with you.
Weird.
Know, right? That's crazy. That right there is elitist.
What's wrong with this country?
That is elitism.
I thought this was America.
I would like to introduce, you guys have all heard Michelle do a beer review at one point. She stole the mic from Justin and Craig. At least she knows how to talk into it, so that's okay, cool. How are you?
She's my lovely wife.
Girl power.
We do need a little bit of girl power on this show. There's not many.
We got you, buddy.
Oh. Okay.
Okay.
I got me a service going on here. Oh, yeah.
I'm going to keep reading. Bob also says that Rookie of the Year, Angels in the Outfield, Little Giants, all great sports movies from my youth. I couldn't agree more. I think they're all awesome.
The Rookie of the Year was terrible.
Rookie of the Year was hilarious.
It was good.
It was all right. So funny.
I have an idea. Let's drink beer.
Okay.
Is that Tim? Does Tim have a beer?
It doesn't matter. Everyone take a beer.
Tim,
you want.
I already know what this is.
No, you don't. Well, yeah, because you saw the...
I didn't see anything,
I promise
you.
He didn't see it.
I promise you. But I do think I know what this is.
Okay, what is it? Then tell us, guy who knows everything.
Oh, soap.
Soap. So it tastes to me... It's clearly an IPA of sorts.
Clearly.
Could be a double IPA.
Clearly.
But it also has a very a flavor that is very reminiscent to me of Tioga Sequoia's General Sherman.
It's not. It's
final good. Answer?
Actually, this is very good.
Horrible.
Wait, this is an IPA. You can't like this.
I do like it.
What?
This is probably
if
one that
you like
I...
You are not my husband. Is that you don't like
this is one
good
that
IPAs.
Picked.
You like shitty IPAs. I haven't had this. Is it good?
It's very good.
Can I? Is it a double IPA? Can I at least ask that?
It is.
I believe it is.
A triple
IPA.
Just kidding. I don't know if that's a thing. It's a double IPA.
It's a real... Because
it's a quadruple IPA.
I get that. They make those now. There are weirdos who... And soon there will be a... What
quadruple.
Quintuple.
No one's done this before.
A quintuple. A quintuple IPA. Right, exactly.
This is, in fact, a double IPA. Of course you would get this.
The more I drink it, I take that back. It's not that good.
It's not good. It's terrible. It honestly tastes like soap.
Well, you
to
have
me.
To finish it, so I don't give a shit if you like it or not.
Really bitter.
Dems the rules.
Dems the rules.
Dems the rules.
If you haven't,
not my thing.
How can we tell our listeners to go Google search that?
I don't
or
have
YouTube
to finish
search
it.
It's Michael Jackson.
It's so.
No, that's ignorant.
Shimon.
Oh, that's ignorant.
We are like children because we are constantly sending each other
Shimona.
Funny YouTube
videos. I would
videos.
Suggest to taste this beer, you would actually go to a highest mountaintop, grab the biggest pine tree you can, lick it, and there you go. Juniper at its finest.
No, that's not juniper.
That's not.
Pine.
No, that's you and Tim. Craig.
You're the same person.
You and Craig have been friends since... Child?
Fourth grade.
So you guys, for some reason, have a very weird perspective of what juniper is. Juniper is gin. If you drink gin, that flavor is juniper. This is pine.
It's pine.
This does not taste like
agree
gin.
Agree to disagree.
I think you need to go
do not
lick
dictate.
On a juniper bush.
First of all,
what they smell like.
You don't tell me what I'm supposed to lick
I'll
on.
I'll tell you everything.
Yes, I will.
Lick
also,
it.
Also, I don't want to hear beer reviews from a guy wearing a cowboy hat.
Giddy up. I drink Coors.
Yeah, with Coors.
Coors.
Yeah, what's Coors?
It's Coors.
It's Coors.
You got the double IPA. So you shacked
it. What do you think of it, Michelle? You give us your review.
I've been talking about it. It's not my favorite. At all. It's real hard. It's very bitter for me. There's an odd aftertaste.
It does taste
a bit like some type of pine tree.
It's very piney.
Where is the waste bucket?
It's the aftertaste that
bugs me. I'm not
going to
finish that.
I have a question for you. Could you explain to me, because I like IPAs.
Yeah.
Let me wash it down with
Zima. I think this is terrible. But there's no way I would be able to know what a double... Like, how do you know that that's a double IPA? Tell me how I can tell if it's
worse.
A double IPA.
I know. I feel the alcohol burn in my throat.
So it's just a higher potency IPA.
Yeah.
You're not doubling the flavor of the IPA. You're just doubling the alcohol content.
Well, arguably, you are doubling everything.
Marshall Schott. What does IPA stand for?
India Pale Ale. Are you kidding me?
I'm learning. I'm not a learned man.
She's a learned
asking
woman.
A question and you gave an asshole response.
I thought she was trying to trick me.
No, I wasn't.
I thought she was trying to trick me.
Apologize.
I wasn't.
Apologize.
Is it India? India.
It stands for IP a lot.
India Pale Ale.
I pee a lot when I drink.
Finish your beers, please. If you can't finish your beers, you're not going to be
at
the table.
So I'm it's a double IPA. That changes my perspective.
It absolutely is double IPA.
I'm going to go with, I'm trying to think of local, don't dump it in the ice. There's
Dude,
a sink.
Do not dump it. I'll drink it. Don't waste That's beer.
I actually don't think it's that bad. I haven't given my review yet because you guys won't,
but I'll drink it
because you guys won't shut up while I try to review these beers.
Everyone mute.
I will tap out of getting it right. Is it local? Is it Californian or?
I don't know this brand. So, let me read it. San Diego, California.
Okay, if it's San Diego, okay, so then is it Alesmith?
No, it's Mission Brewery Shipwreck Double IPA.
Yeah. I've had this before.
I've never had it before, and I don't like it.
I don't either.
Well, I don't think you like double IPA jars. This is very...
I need a towel or something.
So I'm going to read... You didn't read anything about this. I will read about it. A style of beer curiously born on the foggy shores of Father... Junipero.
Junipero.
No, that's a place. It's not.
It's
nothing
Junipero.
To do with juniper.
It's Junipero.
Nothing to do with juniper.
Oh, sorry. Father Junipero Serra's I've never heard of that before.
Juniperos Cerros.
That's what it is. Yeah. So it says, first founding mission, our own vigorous entry is one rebellious IPA, quick on the trigger. I know what that's like. And brimming with a bounty of hop ingenuity. This is a big, bold, brazen beer, a restless vision of a new America brewed by Mission Breweries.
Can I summarize? It sucks.
I don't think it sucks, actually.
You know what?
I don't like it at all.
It is not. It is 9.25% alcohol, dude. I think that's.
And look at the size of the can. That's all you need to get drunk. You drink all of that, you're drunk.
That's why they do it. It's they are huge can, 1-quart cans.
That is massive.
I have to tell you, from a marketing standpoint, their packaging is cool.
It's hella cool.
Yeah, no, that's probably why Timmy picked it up. He's a creature of vision. Like, he's a visual creature.
Well, look at me, after all.
It does. I picked her up.
Was it an impulse buy, Timmy?
It was an impulse buy.
Like, you were already checking out, you had everything you needed, and then you're like, ooh, I need that.
I'll take two of those.
Yeah. I guess I'll take you. Yeah, yeah. He's the last one on the shelf.
On the outside.
Last one on the shelf, Jers, yeah.
Whatever.
Mm. I already drank mine. This is somebody else's. I can't drink it all. Somebody do that.
I actually think it's pretty good.
All right, you ready for the next one?
Well, let me finish this 10% fucking...
I'm sorry that you can't finish your beer.
Now you know how we
feel.
Harness
your inner illegal 18-year-old drinking self.
I need a Miller Lite rinse, though.
A Miller Lite rinse. That's like a car wash.
You want a Zima rinse? Because I have that.
I do not like Zima. That is a... I appreciate people who do, Michelle, and I know you love it.
I need... What's happening?
It's your glass back.
Oh. Could you pass me a Miller Lite so I can rinse out, please?
That's
can somebody just give
Craig,
and rinse out?
We're back to Marshall and Timmy time over here.
Marshall and Timmy time.
Whoa. Would
you mind showing that to the
camera? Would you look into Marshall. My eyes?
Would you?
It's Marshall and Timmy time.
When I look into your eyes.
It's a classic.
Eyes.
If he gets this one.
Oh. Show's over.
Which one is it?
I'm not looking. I refuse you better not. To look.
Give it to Gail. Give Stop. It to Gail.
He's so totally looking. You can look now. You can
wait,
look
it,
now.
Wait, give it to me.
I promise you I saw nothing. Don't. I'm already looking
no,
this
I know
way,
you're so. Looking at half of these.
Wait, we got to put
and
it on
I've
air.
But I've gotten more air. Than half right. wrong. Oh, okay. I've gotten more than half wrong. If I was looking at half of these.
No, well, I think you're looking at them all, and then you're like, I better get this one wrong, because there's
if
no way
that
I could get
does,
it.
If that does not define the Jersey mentality, is never trusting anyone, but always thinking that they're fucking cheating.
Yeah, dude. Never trusting anyone.
That's a good looking beer.
This far in life.
That's a good looking
I always
beer.
Believe everything is a trap. That's why I've lived so long. Could it be a trap, sir? I always believe everything is a trap.
That's not my cup.
I got to be honest. Chugging that Mission Shipwreck double IPA kind of.
Got to be honest. And I think you know.
Wrecked him, Denner. Ooh. Killed him.
Covered in layers and hair, right? I'm starting to sing more like Justin. He's a bad influence.
Yeah, he's a terrible influence. Also,
all right, what is it, Marshall?
Should we, maybe at the end of this episode, I will tell you right now, this is the weird point. If you're skipping over shit, you're going to miss it. Like 20 minutes after the end of this episode, I'm going to plug in our rendition of Shimmer by Fuel.
Oh.
I haven't
and that's
heard
it. Don't talk about it
I
again.
Haven't heard it.
Oh,
it's good.
We heard it in Vegas. It was amazing.
Did they? Is it made? It made it to the radio. Then it's on the airwaves.
It's on the airwaves. Yeah, yeah.
It could. I bet it could.
It's
top
good.
20 at least.
Remember
dude.
When I was doing this and you were like,
"Stop plugging your nose."
Stop plugging your nose.
I think we should at least get it to Fuel.
Yeah. Oh.
They need to hear it.
Oh, we got to get it to Fuel. He's my friend.
Because by the end of it, we're like, "This song rocks."
You just done it.
Hey, what is
it? Ooh. That is that's like Coors Light.
It's a good Coors
Light.
That's a good.
My dad used to drink it back in '85 in the Bulldog Villas.
Yeah, he can't drink. That won't help him. Somewhere beyond this, I know.
Or, you're covered like Bush in Light, maybe. And that's it's very light. Day.
It's very light.
Type, please. Type of beer.
Type of beer.
American Light Lager.
Okay. American Light Lager.
Let's just take
lager.
A gander.
If guess? It says light on the can, that's an American Light Lager.
It doesn't say light
okay,
on the
so
can.
So I'm wrong.
Can. It's, so of I'm course, wrong. A can.
No. Keep guessing. You're
it
close.
Is a lager. Nice job.
So far, 90% of what you so dumbasses have fucking brought to
it
me.
It is a lager. Well done.
That's actually kind of difficult, to be honest with you.
It's good. It's very good.
It's really good. Yeah.
Oh, you like this?
I do like this.
Timmy likes this.
I like
your
it.
Pick, Jersey?
Dude, it is one of my picks. And
do you know what it is?
The ginger likes
no
the
idea.
Beer.
I actually think you and I might like. There's a couple of these that I kind of want to get more of.
Yeah.
Also,
this
all of mine
of
I have
it
six packs of. Most of them in the garage,
namesake.
So we can drink more.
I know. I just want to go swimming. Oh, this is ginger.
Yeah. Can we be done drinking beer so I can do things that are more fun? There's nothing more fun than what we're doing right now. You're an idiot.
This is fun.
Keep going. Get make your guess. It's gone now.
I already did. I said American Light Lager. So.
Type, please.
American Light Lager.
He just told you.
Do you want me to change it?
Brand, please.
Brand. Kick a guess.
AB InBev.
I don't know what that is, but
that means there's like 14 right. people.
Hey,
14 brewers.
Is that the same as Bill Div Debo?
Yes, that's it.
Oh, it's Red Stripe, dude.
It's Red Stripe. It's so good.
Why is
it's
it so good? Why is it so good?
So I meant to say Jamaican lager. Yeah, is what
yeah, you got the lager.
It's good.
Maybe we had it in, we had a whole bunch in.
Oh, Red Stripe is so. I'll drink the rest of that actually. If that's there's good. More left, yeah.
I have the rest of the six packs in there too, so we can drink that. We're drinking all of these later.
Oh, there you go. All right. Here.
That's good.
All right, we're down to five left, Marshall. Five left.
While you're pouring, we're going to read more comments here. So we got Andrew Webster says, do they even see us? We absolutely see you. I'm sort of blocking the camera so I don't see the beers they're pouring, though. So.
You're seeing everything, and you're not really trying not to see it.
And Bob Abbott says they can read the comments. That's true. Let's see. And replying to Andrew says, oh, Andrew's replying to himself. So I guess they can. Awesome. They read my question on the show. You're welcome, Andrew.
Okay, do not look. I'm serious, Marshall.
I'm not looking, homie.
Do
I promise
not fucking
you.
Look.
Listen, player, I got you. I'm not fucking looking. Jersey.
Turn around.
Brian. Okay, here. Okay. Great question. I promise you, I'm not looking. Have Jersey or Tim, this comes from Brent Martin. Have Jersey or Tim ever brewed?
I have not. Tim is, I don't know if you have Tim. I have
assisted.
Not, but. I have brewed with Marshall once.
That is what brewing is.
Have I brewed alone? No. But Marshall walked me through the process once.
Like
and it was really cool. And I remember my memory of it was this is going to change the. This is going to help you guess, but there's nothing I can do.
It's champagne.
Jesus.
Sorry. That's going to change things a little
Holy
bit, I know. But
crud.
For your listeners to know, he did hear a champagne cork pop, so that might influence his guess. No, but you walked me through the whole process, and I remember initially being like, this is it? This is how easy it is to make beer? And you're like, well, it looks easy, but it's a little harder than that, dude.
Well,
you're like, making beer is easy, making good beer is hard.
I don't know if I ever said those words, actually. I made
that up.
You might have made, thank you, though, for the vote of confidence there. Tim, you've been around multiple
many of your batches. I've never done it myself.
And you've never I don't think you've ever stuck around from start to finish, but you've been
probably not.
You've been a part of every
I've milled a lot of grain.
Milled a lot of grain and you've kegged and you've helped me keg a lot of beer, yeah. So you've got those bookends, but everything in between. Though I do feel like you've been around if we were to piece together all the times that you've been there, you've definitely brewed a batch of beer.
Yeah, I can buy a case of beer, no problem.
So do you feel like a brewer? Do you feel? Would you?
No,
say?
No.
What do you do on a brewing
podcast? We both talked
about
before that we like feel fake as hell that we're reviewing people's beers that they put time and effort into and are really good at making, and we're just two ham and egging idiots.
I'm so glad you're like, finally seeing my vision.
No. I get it. But you ready for this one, bud?
Oh, I think I know what this is already.
I think I can smell it from here, Marshall. Do I smell like a cinnamon from here?
It's a sour beer.
Oh,
remember, so remember how Jersey's always like, you can tell just by the way it smells, Timmy.
No, he looked at it and said it was a sour.
That was one of the later.
That actually, Jedi mind trick shit.
I love sour beers.
Oh, so do I.
This smells good.
I also taste like a berry.
Well, yeah, it's clearly there's some sort of berry.
Shit, dude, you're never gonna guess this, but I hope you do.
That's a good one. Right? That's a good one.
Berry.
Oh man, that is good.
That is sour.
I like it.
This is a good sour beer. Hey, listen, Timmy. Before while they're all talking over there, and I have to drown them out. We used to have one bottle of the Queens of the Lake. Should we open it up?
Yes.
Okay. Wait. Can we?
Yes,
can
we should.
What's the type?
Oh, this is a. Well, I mean, it's going to be an American sour ale.
Okay. You're never going to guess. You might guess who made it, but you're not going to guess the name of it because I don't think you've ever had it before.
Is it... So,
go ahead. By the way, I picked a good one. I'm not a huge sour guy, and this is delicious.
I picked a good one.
It's good.
So, oh, you picked this?
It's good. I like it. You like it?
Okay.
Girl.
Well, of course he picked it. He's a sour guy.
He loves sour beers, dude.
I've actually never bought one other than you? At Pendragon.
Marshall, can I read you the bottle?
Sure.
Silence! All right. Here's the bottle. This the rare barrel is full of complex and risky.
Okay, so
adventures.
It's the rare barrel.
No, that's not correct.
They're out of Berkeley. We love the Rare Barrel. We do. We here absolutely we love the Rare Barrel. So this is not.
We took a portion of our dark sour, blended it with Creek Lambic.
Ooh.
Matured it in our original 17 wine barrels that begin our sour program, then blended in our golden sour Felix before like corking and bottle conditioning for several months.
I love sour beer.
It's not the Rare Barrel?
No.
So Felix, I know where that comes
from.
Oh,
it is. It's another brewery and the Rare Barrel.
Yeah. I know what this is. I've seen this on the internet.
Go ahead.
I don't know it. I won't know it.
New Belgium and Rare Barrel.
That's right. That's right. So New Belgium has a whole sour
really
program.
Good.
This is amazing.
This is like one from Pendragon that we got. Is it the Guinevere or?
Oh, that was way different. That was like the Guinevere was amazingly sour.
Oh, this is so good, dude.
This is super.
This is much cleaner.
This is, well, you realize.
Timmy's got me turned on to sours, dude.
But you have to understand, the Rare Barrel and New Belgium, them together, that's like bringing Macho Man Randy Savage and like that combination is just money. This is absolutely fantastic. We love the Rare Barrel. They're an amazing. All they do is sour beers. They're out in Berkeley.
And delicious.
It's absolutely delicious, and everything they make is amazing.
You will.
That's good.
We don't do a lot of like brewery promotion. You have to go to the Rare Barrel if you're in Berkeley. You have to go.
I mean,
to
I'll go. This is delicious.
It's absolutely
it's
delicious.
Man.
Yeah.
Do we have any more left?
Oh, it's so, no, it's gone.
So good.
Oh, I love sour beer. Tim knows that.
It's got a great nose feel, too.
Yeah.
You know what? Hey, yeah, Craig.
I like it.
Can you go, if you go open the fridge in the garage, there is a big bottle on the very bottom shelf called like Queens of the Lake. Bring that over. We'll finish with that.
Is it sour?
We got another one. We got another couple more.
We have four more, bro. Let's do
it. All right, I'm ready.
Ready?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it. We're going to go fast on these last three.
Okay,
four, whatever.
Can you close your eyes or pull your hat down over your head or something?
I'm not actually looking.
You aren't actually looking.
All right.
Close your eyes.
Give me your hand,
darling.
Oh, that's super good.
Can
oh my
you
God.
Feel my
So Tim, tell us where you found that at, because
that was at Total Wine.
That was at Total Wine.
Yeah.
See,
that's
I
a
went
local.
To
hey, I walked around there. I'm like looking, like it. Well,
it must not have been cheap. That's not a cheap.
A total moron. I have no idea what I'm buying, and I finally found the sour beers. I at least had to get one.
Yeah.
No idea.
You picked a very, very,
it was
good.
Very
you
good.
Yeah. What'd you think of it, Michelle?
Tim knows I love sour beers. We first experienced it at a brewery sort of microbrew. I don't know what it was called. Tap It in San Luis Obispo, California.
Yeah, great brewery. Another
so
great brewery.
So we did a couple flights and they had some sours there. My first experience with sours was there. Loved them.
Jersey.
Loved them.
So Tap It is known for their IPA. They have a lot of IPAs is my understanding. I've never been there.
Well, the company sold, but it's still there. It's really fun. It's sort of in an industrial location. Outside of the San Luis Obispo area.
Jersey.
Yeah, I've not been there.
Fun. It's fun.
Right there.
And good beers. Okay, here we go.
All right.
When are we going to review the Top Gun 2 trailer?
I've not seen it yet.
No, but Bob wanted us to review the Top Gun 2 trailer.
So I have to throw it up on the computer and we'll, I guess, review it as we go along?
Okay.
No, I don't want to do that. That sounds stupid. Sorry, Bob.
It's good.
No, I'll just summarize for him. Bob, he's obviously in the back seat. His harnesses are not attached correctly. Like if you watch the trailer, they're falling off of his shoulders. And I believe when they're driving through the canyon with the mountains with snow on them, I think that's Star Wars Canyon in Alaska, which we fly through all the time.
There's your review.
So this is something I know you're pouring beer right now, Jers, but you do. You guys go out on. You do these flights out of Fresno, but you guys go over the Mojave, right? You guys fly.
We fly. Our main airspace is actually between here and Nevada, and it's actually mostly Nevada. It's Death Valley and west of there.
Yeah. So, that's awesome, man.
All right, buddy.
Enough all right,
talk
here we go.
About cool right. shit like yeah. flying jets. Why don't we talk about your dumb beers?
Oh, God. I know what this is.
Ooh, that smells good. What were you going to
say? This is by Starbucks.
Hang on.
You, though. You got to guess. This is a nitro brew.
Hey, Patton Oswalt actually likes this one. Patton Oswalt actually likes
this. This is really good.
It's a cold brew by Starbucks.
It's definitely a coffee stout.
This is a nitro brew. I want a scone. Maybe a better attitude.
I don't think you know what nitro means.
Okay,
I don't think Patton knows what nitro
coffee
means.
Coffee stout. Got it.
Definitely a coffee stout. There's coffee in there.
No one cares what nitro means.
No. You might not, Michelle.
Are you ready for your first miss?
Nitroglyceride.
This is not a coffee stout.
Is it
nitro means rock and roll, man.
A porter. porter. That's a
you
very
fucked up big time.
Very
dude.
Dark porter. Yeah.
X. Strike two, son.
You could have given me more time. You could have given me more time.
Nope. You know what? Nope. I'm not going to. You can't miss again. You've got three more after this, and you can't miss again.
This is really fucking good.
The tagline. The tagline on this is easy Timothy? Like Sunday morning.
Ooh, Lionel Richie.
That's why I got it. That's why I got it.
It's so good.
And the the place that makes it is something is a place that you love. You're gonna shit yourself if you don't guess this.
Firestone Walker. I already did.
No, I'm not. Don't tell me when. What, or is it final answer?
You know that I love Firestone Walker.
So Firestone Walker coffee stout. You already missed on the. Coffee
no, that's
stout.
There. So do I. Yeah, you do. Craig loves love the Merlin. Yeah.
Is final answer Firestone Walker?
Oh, this is so good. This is so good. It's good. Yeah, that's my final answer.
Okay, it's not Firestone Walker. It's Drake's.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Black Robusto. This is a fantastic. This is one of the darkest porters, though. And so.
Look what Timmy picked.
Dude, you did. Look what you did Timmy way picked. Better than me.
Look what Timmy picked.
I thought I was going to pick all the exotic shit, and you were going to get like Red Stripe and Sapporo, and I got all the Red Stripes and Sapporo. You got the exotic shit. This is my number two.
I'll tell you what, Tim. This, I've not had this in probably 3 years, and it is. So
it's really good.
It's delicious,
good.
Isn't it?
It's so good.
Dude, put a dollop of vanilla ice cream in there. It would be fucking fantastic.
So, Marshall, can I say something? So from a woman's standpoint, I know a lot of chicks. I'm going to speak for the world, apparently.
I was going to say, you're being very sexist.
I am. Right? I am. Yeah. I am. A lot of us are. Okay. I am often afraid of dark beers. But when I started drinking them, and I love coffee, right? Like coffee and chocolate. A lot of these porters and stouts. This is a porter, right? Taste,
yeah.
They have that flavor profile, which I love. And lovely about them, their high alcohol content. So win, win, win.
So I do think this one has a very high alcohol content.
I'm going with 9.7.
But not.
I love when Tim tries to guess the
alcohol. Usually it's pretty close.
Actually, 6.3, not too bad. It's like an IPA. Yeah, 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 not bad at all.
What a great beer. What a great pick, Timmy. This, well done.
Tim,
well done, my friend.
Cheers to you.
Mine's
on all
already
your
gone.
I have
good
no
job.
Idea
good
which
job,
ones.
Honey.
I have no idea which ones either of you guys picked at this point.
You will need to.
With nothing in the glass.
You will need a Miller Lite. Clean your glasses. Here.
So Drake's is out of San Leandro. That's
did you say San Diego?
San Leandro.
Oh, San Leandro.
Up in the Bay Area. And they do Drake's does amazing, amazing beers. They've got
this is great.
Their 1500 Pale Ale is one of the best. It's so good.
This porter is delicious.
Everything Drake's does. They're old school too. They've been around for a long time. Everything what?
That's amazing.
It was good. That was also from Total Wine, I believe.
They're all from Total Wine.
We've got three more beers. We don't have time for stand-ins.
Oh, that's this is
that's
the
why rich. I bought it. That's why I bought it.
He's, no, I didn't buy that. That's Timmy, man. That's
Timmy.
Delicious.
Timmy bought that.
Okay, but this next one I did
super
buy.
Good. All right,
I'll give you a little run up. When I was deployed the last time to the desert, which was like 6 years ago, you could only have two beers a night, and they only had like three types of beer.
You better
and
this make
was
them count.
One, and so you didn't have a choice, right? Well, we found ways around it, but usually you just get really in good with the bartenders and they'd hook you up. But
of course.
Anyways, this was one of the three beers that was available and it was the highest in alcohol content. So it was the one I picked every time. There's the run up. All right. You ready?
All right. Eyes closed.
Eyes closed.
Eyes closed. Tim, we got to come up with something to talk about.
Let's talk about sex, baby.
Let's talk about you and me.
Let's talk about. Damn.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
We're back on air.
Craig's over here in his tank top break
Let's
dancing.
Let's talk about it. All right, you're good. You can look now.
All right, cool. Yeah, that's right.
See, Tinder is it. Like how I picked all the different ones, and he's
did all the normal ones.
I tried to pick things that actually had meaning to me, or you know, or something that we might share a memory of.
I do love you guys.
You
know,
Tim did was aimlessly wander around the local store.
That's exact.
True story. I like to see the camera footage. I'm all
I already know what this is. I already know what it is.
Oh, sure? Yeah. Oh, do you? Yeah.
This is Jake would be proud of me. I already know what this is.
From nice. Sniff.
Knowledge then. Hit us with knowledge.
Hit me it's, with
well,
your best
I,
shot.
Okay, so I don't want to be okay. I'm being a little overconfident.
Yeah, you are.
This is an English beer.
Okay.
So we have to talk like an English accent. No. This is an English beer. What kind of
English? This is a bloody beer.
No. The beer wasn't from the desert. The beer was three types of beer. Don't let them distract you. It wasn't brewed in the desert.
No, no. This is from London. I'm very proud of this beer, is my guess. Just based on the smell alone. I know this. I've drank so much of this.
All right.
It's London Pride. Yeah. Or it's
you. Winner! That's it. You won.
Did I win?
You won. That's
holy
your third.
Holy shit.
That's your third win, so you win.
Steaks
so,
for all of us.
I will tell. Let me review the beer, though. Let me review the beer. I love Fuller's.
You're going to keep reviewing it, but it doesn't matter anymore.
It does matter.
Great job, Marshall.
I can't believe you stuck that off the smell.
This is a very, very... So
he does
anything,
all the time. He's all, Tim, did you fart? Oh, yes, I did.
Oh, God.
Tim, did you have too much burritos?
Oh, my God.
Did you eat Don Pepe's shrimp burrito? Oh.
Yes, I did.
This is one of the most identifiable beers, in my opinion. I feel like Jake will agree with me.
I'm sorry, man, but I just smell biscuits.
That is good.
It's biscuits and
Jersey,
fruit
did you buy that beer?
With like fruit marmalade on it. Yeah. So that's the Fuggles hops.
I can't believe you stuck that, dude. I'm so impressed.
That was off of aroma alone, dude. This
was one of three beers they had. The other one was like a Bud Light. I can't remember. And everybody they're always out of these because we're like, oh, it's the highest in alcohol content. It's not high. It's like 5%. But if you can only have so many beers.
It's so good.
You don't care about flavor. You care about alcohol percentage.
But it doesn't matter. This is so flavorful and so delicious.
I can't believe you stuck that.
Oh, my God.
Are you serious now?
The cowboy is drunk. Didn't we also drink this when we were in Milwaukee?
Yes, we did.
At that bar?
There was a... No, not we weren't in Milwaukee. We were in Minneapolis.
Minneapolis.
Yeah.
At that one English bar.
And they gave me a shirt. Remember they gave me the shirt because I begged for a shirt. And it was a... They had four taps and it was all Fuller's
And they
beers.
Were the English pool taps,
That's
weren't they?
That's right. They were so delicious.
Yeah. That's the last time we had this together.
This is... such an amazingly good beer, and thank you for whoever got this one.
I got it, bud, because I was like, you know, it meant something to me because I drank it in the desert, and then when we drank it together that time, you were like, God, this is so good.
It's so good.
So I try to pick things that I could, at least we have a shared experience with. This is it.
It's so fucking identifiable. It's so, that if I'm a brewery, I have no ambitions to start a professional brewery. I want a beer that people taste and immediately go, oh, that's Fuller's. I know that that's Fuller's.
So the ones that you've done that to so far are Maui Brewing Company, their IPA, the Big Swell.
Yeah.
You nailed that right. You're like, this is Maui Brewing Company.
Well, but I'll tell you what. The thing with Maui was that was an association with clean IPA that I think is fermented with a very clean yeast.
Yeah, man, how many fucking IPAs have you drank in your entire life? But the fact that you can nail down to a specific location, that was impressive.
The other one was
Mickey's Malt Liquor, which...
ESB, basically.
I actually, when I picked that one out, I was laughing my ass off because I'm like, this will be a, you know, I don't think you drink a lot of malt liquor.
That was the one I'm the most proud of. I nailed that one right off the bat.
Well, so I remember plenty of times in college driving around brown bagging Old English and other malt liquors because it gets you drunk faster. And I still, when I tasted it, was like, this doesn't taste like anything I remember. I don't remember malt liquor tasting. You stuck that one. So I'm proud of you. And then the London Pride. London Pride was... You sniffed it and you were like, I'm very proud of this beer from London.
I did that because my strong guess was that it was London.
Yeah, you're like a magician, my friend. Hey, you know what? I wanted to unmask you on this one for being a fool, and you've made
us
all look like fools.
Oh, I'm a fool.
I'm very impressed. That was impressive.
But don't we still have a couple more beers
to
do?
We have two more beers.
I might still prove to our listeners that I'm actually worth my weight.
Well, this has been very impressive. I'm convinced. It's worth a steak to me.
What's amazing is that we've... stuck this out the entire time Craig has been cleaning up a broken glass. Can you close that door, please?
He's the biggest guy in this room. How did he get the drunkest?
Rookie.
All right, you ready to move on?
Yeah, let's move on here.
Okay, so there's two left, one of Timmy's and one of mine.
Let's do it.
Pick, me or Timmy?
Timmy.
Okay, Timmy's it is. Don't look. Look away. Look away, Marshall, look away.
One Marco Schott asks, what's up, fellas?
And I know Marshall.
Him. Sounds like
I
somebody
know him.
Hey, Marco, thanks for sending me all the Pokemon gifts.
Is it's weird.
You?
Marco looks just like
also,
you.
Also, I just upgraded
isn't that crazy?
I just upgraded my Dragonair
like
to a Dragonite, dude, and it's over 3,000
CP, bro.
This
is not a Pokemon Go podcast. We don't need to...
Marco, my Dragonair or Dragonite is over 3,000 CP, bro.
Marco is
and
my brother,
two
of
people
course.
That listen to this podcast know what that means.
Yeah, all two people who listen to this show, exactly.
You're up to over 9.
You scoff Pokemon Go if you want, but it's the thing that gets me the most quality time with my son.
Since which I absolutely love,
perfect.
Particularly given the times I do. But I tried to play I don't understand the point of that game. I just don't.
The point of the game is that my son will text me and be like, Dad, there's a raid going on over there. Let's go. And I, guess what? That means I get to hang out with my son.
You get to hang out with your son, yeah.
I tried Fortnite to hang out with him, and it wasn't working because I'm terrible at Fortnite.
Well, it doesn't matter, though.
Did you see
but Pokemon
Go
is easy.
Just,
anybody can do it.
That's the because, kid that's that because, just won the Fortnite Open won $3 million and is 16
Aiden,
years old.
Aiden was actually pissed he couldn't participate in that because he's on vacation. But he wanted to play in the... Yeah,
the Fortnite to play in the Open. Yeah, it was like video game Nerd Central.
I'm telling you, when the kid plays Fortnite, I'm kind of amazed at how good he is.
Your kid,
Justin,
where does that $3
million?
$3 million.
So the you know how you ask your kids what they want to be when they grow up? And Aniston's like, I want to be a YouTube influencer. I'm like, that's dumb. That's not going to amount to anything.
Aniston
Do you
is
realize
Jersey's daughter.
That the highest YouTube influencer is like a seven-year-old kid in Britain and, or no, in South Korea.
South
and
Korea.
She's making like $8 million a month. Something like that.
It's like $8 million a year, but nonetheless, they just...
Why do you have to question everything Jersey says?
But I think it's
so,
agree
I am full of... There's a few things I'm full of. Random knowledge.
And shit.
And shit.
Yeah, yeah.
So this 8-year-old that Jersey's referring to just bought an $8 million apartment in South Korea. The parents bought an $8 million
apartment. And all she does is review like toys on YouTube.
That's it. 100% reviews toys.
Millions of subscribers.
So, Brulosophy Podcast listeners, I'm sorry to say this in the last episode. Yeah.
But let me ask this.
We're now going to review toys in South Korea.
I am now going to start a podcast with my children reviewing toys in South Korea.
We glazed over this. Is this really the 100th episode?
Number 100,
of course it is.
Dude. Yeah.
Kudos to you and everything that you've done.
Oh, my God. Salud. I know what this is. I know what this is.
Oh, dude. Let's do a toast to Marshall.
Oh, let's do a toast to Marshall.
A toast to Brulosophy, not
a toast to Brulosophy.
We would not be where... We would not be who we are today if it weren't for Jersey, Tim, Malcolm, Jake,
Phil,
Cade,
actually, Jersey,
Ray,
Tim have nothing to do with it.
Jersey
Matt,
and Tim,
Brian.
we're just fucking latch-ons. Like, all you guys. Matt Del Fiocco, Brian, dude, I love you. Jake, you know I love you, homie.
Yeah, Ray.
And the most solemn member of Brulosophy, Malcolm. I love you too, man.
Why is he so solemn?
Oh, dude, he's always the guy that's like all in control.
He's trying to stop us from doing stupid shit.
I love that cap.
Good luck with that.
I love that cap because he's also a veteran, so he's badass.
Hey,
he is.
Cheers to all of you guys.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers to another 200.
To Brulosophy. Yeah.
Just don't spill it on the computer. That's our brains
Craig.
Here.
The drunk cowboy.
I just got glass on my shoe over here.
What do you
okay.
think it is, Marshall?
I'll sweep up when we're done.
Marshall, what do you got?
Oh, it's an IPA. But I know this very well.
No, it's not. Is it?
Yes.
I can just look.
I've had this before. Ooh. That is not good. You know what I get, Timmy? I get juniper. It tastes like gin.
Well, thank you.
Now that he knows he's
thank
won the
you.
Bet, he's just getting all buff.
You are a learned man now.
You are right, sir.
So you're saying the style is IPA?
Oh, yeah, 100%.
Okay, do you remember all those episodes, Marshall, where I'm like, Timmy, don't say anything. Just say pale. If we think it's an IPA, let's say pale ale. That way, we don't get made to look like fools. Maybe you should take that advice.
It's a little juicy, though.
It smells old. It smells like it's... I bet if you look at the date, I bet it's at least 4 months
old. You know what? That's one thing I didn't check.
Is the dates. I told you guys when you went out
to
buy these.
I know.
I don't see a date on your home.
See? Me neither.
It's very, very like juniper piney.
I don't want to give it away, but if you turn this bottle in, you get 5 cents back.
Thank you.
Oh, we're in California. Cool, yeah.
Thank you for acknowledging our taste.
Oh, shit. I was joking. I didn't think you could actually get anything out of that.
I
don't like it.
Just go with your guess because you've already won. You've already won.
Is it Sierra Nevada's hazy?
No, it is Tap It Brewing Company Pale Ale.
Oh, it's very hazy for a pale ale. It's super piney.
Sierra Nevada, you would like that. So, I've got that on tap in my place, and you love it.
Sierra Nevada Pale Ale, I do.
So
love
you would know if that's this. Why would you guess that?
I said it was hazy. There's Sierra Nevada's
I'm
hazy.
I'm not
going to
drink this.
Dude.
Yeah. I gotta be honest. I love Tap It. They've made some great stuff. I'm not a big fan of this beer.
I think you might just have to pull
it. So this was a big strikeout.
Oh, man.
It's so piney.
It doesn't matter.
It smells like overripe papaya with pine salt.
You don't even know what papaya is.
Are you?
I used to.
Oh, yeah. A papaya is a vegetable. It grows on a tree.
I used to take the branches off the papaya trees, and you could break the leaves off the top, and then you could sword fight with them, and whoever's broke first.
So, dude,
that was a bad
so
buy
an IPA, India Pale Ale.
No, I don't care if it's
ale,
bad. You're still
going to
finish it.
There's a thing with IPA right now. I think people are kind of moving away from India Pale Ale, and it's the style is just IPA now.
Well, I think you just say pale ale. We learned this because if you say India Pale Ale, it's not. Like,
no,
oh, there's a pale ale.
There's a, There is a connotation to IPA that is different than just PA, if you will. They're different. IPA means higher alcohol, more hops.
You don't even know what you're talking about.
No, you're right. I have no idea.
I love you.
That's right. Yeah.
All right, Marshall, got one more. Let's finish these.
I don't know if I can finish this one. This one's a rough one.
All right, buddy. The cutie growl.
Thank you, Jeremy. He says, congrats on 100. I appreciate that. I can't believe we made 100 episodes. That is a lot of blowhards.
What's this wee shit? Tim, I didn't do shit.
It's a lot of blowhards. That's right.
That's a lot of blowhards blowing hard. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Pass me your glass, Timmy. Glass, Timmy.
Is this the last of the...
This is it, dude.
All right. No, then we're going to finish off with this.
This is it.
We'll do a final century toast with this beautiful House of Pendragon, Lady of the Lakes. I kept calling it Queen this of the Lakes earlier. Yeah,
and then I got to jack up some tri-tips.
Can we play Islands in the Man?
Did you see tips?
Cheers.
That's a funny story. That's what I'll talk about. So Jersey and I were here. What was it? It was early last week, 2 weeks ago. Jersey came over. He was bored. I was bored. So we decided to drink. So I invented a new drink, by the way, guys. It's called Sparkling Screwdriver.
We had that in Vegas. It was amazing.
I doubt I invented it, but I'm going to pretend that I did.
Is this what you made the other night?
Holy Jesus.
They're so good. It's just a screwdriver with grapefruit
sparkling
water.
I actually lost weight getting drunk.
Don't forget, you're going to air the world premiere of...
But that made our Vegas Shimmer trip.
No, we're going to do that. Yeah, we'll do that at the end. You got to wait 5 minutes after this, so...
Oh, my God.
Okay, your turn, Marshall.
All right, here we go.
I think by the smell, I can't drink it.
Oh, I feel like I'm in a tropical jungle running for my life.
It is banana, 100% banana.
Ba-da-da-da-da.
This is... Oh, this is the... I know this. I already know what it is.
What is it?
It's that English banana bread beer.
It's banana bread
beer. It's banana bread beer, yeah.
It's English equals Wells?
Yeah, Wells is English, yeah.
This is dog shit.
So you stuck another one.
Absolute dog shit.
So here's the funny thing. I've seen this on the shelves for the last decade. I've never tried it in my entire life.
I actually like it.
You would.
If I like this.
You would. It's funny when beers will have a name that like you're... Oh, that doesn't really make sense or fit. This is every bit of banana.
I gotta be honest. This is not bad. This is pretty good.
Banana.
Dude.
I like it.
It's very banana forward.
Gotta be honest.
This would be awesome with some pineapple fried rice. I'm just saying.
But yeah, Pat Oswalt's coming in.
It's not bad, dude. I like it.
It's good. It's if you're into banana and I get the bready part of it as well, which is nice. You get that kind of toasty bready thing.
I bet that comes from...
That's
yeast.
It, buddy. It's gone. You did it.
So we have
final results tallied by the Jerseynator.
All right. Jerseynator's going to tell us.
Here were
the
beers reviewed. Line and Kugel Summer Shandy. He guessed Lemon Dosed American Wheat Ale. Good job. But you guessed New Belgium. This was should have been a miss, but it was a Sapporo that you guessed was Coors Banquet. The Taco Truck beer you guessed is an American Ale, Amber DBA. That was an X. The big win for you was the Maui Brewing Company.
That was big.
IPA, which was a big swell.
That was a big one.
Stuck that one. You stuck the Mickey's Malt Liquor.
Yes. I nailed. That was my biggest stick.
Which I can't even...
That was my biggest stick.
I can't even believe it.
Yeah, that was my biggest stick.
We gave you the Left Coast Voodoo American Stout. You guessed that as Firestone Walker, but you got the type. The Hefeweizen, you guessed that. The Double IPA, you know, these are all pretty obscure beers, so of course you're not going to guess the type. Red Stripe, you said was an American Light Lager, but we gave you that one.
Jamaica's close.
Hooray, beer.
I said it was an American premium.
I think we all agreed was one of our favorites was the New Belgium and the Rare Barrel Air on the Side of Awesome Sour, which was delicious. And you guessed that as an American Sour. Don't mix it up.
That was my favorite beer of the day.
That
so
was
far.
Delicious.
Yeah, it was amazing.
You also liked the Black Robusto.
Amazingly good.
You didn't guess that. That was one of your exes, though. You guessed that as a coffee stout, and it was a
coffee
porter. It was a porter.
Yeah, sorry.
It makes me happy inside.
I bet it does.
London Pride, you stuck with that even drinking.
Nailed that one.
Boom.
It's all smell.
Sniffed it
all
and
smell.
Stuck yeah. it.
I've had a lot of London Pride.
Non-sexually, you sniffed it and stuck it. Dude, that was amazing. Tappet Pale Ale, you guess, is Sierra Nevada, which angers me, but no worries. And then the you actually stuck the Wells Fargo, the Wells Banana Bread beer.
That was easy. That
so
was the easiest one.
There were four
one.
That you nailed with the type and brand and name.
So
I declare you the champion, and I treat you to a steak dinner.
That sounds good.
On a day of your choosing.
And you know what? You and I will split Timmy's steak. I would like to.
Timmy can't afford his own steak.
I would like. We are to the end of this show. We've gone way over. We're at about over an hour and a half.
That's good.
Here's the awesome thing. We have one beer left. It's a beer that I brought. It is Lady of the Lakes. It's my last bottle. Tim and I bought these, God, over a year ago. Yeah. It was right when House of Pendragon started their sour program with my friend Sean Wood.
Sean,
that's right. Go Sean. And so Sean Wood, Tommy Caprellian from House of Pendragon, they've got an incredible sour program, all small batch. We spent way too much money on these. I think we'd had a few by the time we were buying these. But so I would just like to say cheers to all of our listeners. First off, if it weren't for you guys listening, there'd be no reason for us to be here. For all of our patrons who are giving us money every month so that we can keep doing this stupid bullshit that we do. But most of all, to all the people who make this possible, which Jersey, Tim, Justin,
love
Craig,
you, buddy.
Everybody.
Cheers.
I love you guys so much. We made it 100. We're going to do another 100 in 2 years. We'll be there. So cheers, guys.
Oh, it's so good.
The Brewlosophy Podcast is made possible by the generous support of our sponsors, as well as all of our rad listeners. We seriously could not do this without you. Cheers to everyone who has subscribed and left a review of our show. It makes a huge difference. If you haven't yet, please consider doing so. Head over to brewlosophy.com/support to view a list of ways you can easily help us to continue producing this podcast. If you want a reward for your support, visit patreon.com/brewlosophy. Thanks again for listening. We'll be back next week with another episode of the Brewlosophy Podcast. Until then, think beer. Start off the morning with some hot tea, lemon and honey, cause it soothes my bro. Put some herb in the bowl, yeah, it's homegrown. Ain't gotta go through no middle man no more. Life is good, the likelihood of me.
No, I don't want to do this. I literally do not want to do this.
Neither do I. I hate this song.
She called me from the car. Just when I was low, feeling sort of stable.
Yeah, we sound good.
And all that she entails. And all she keeps inside is it on the label. She says she's ashamed. She take it for a while. Can I be a friend? We'll forget the past. Maybe I'm not evil. But I break out the band. Here and now. Will we ever be again?
I can't.
I have found all that shimmers in this world. This song is dumb.
The song is dumb. Stop holding your nose.
I can't do it.
Stop holding your nose. Kill this. Kill it.
Street champagne dream. Strawberry surprise. Pink linen and white paper. Lavender and cream. Fields of butterflies, reality is gazer. She's a love, is for fools who fall behind. Somewhere in between, I never really know a killer from a satyr. I break out the pen, here and now, will we ever be? All that shimmers in this world is sure to fade away.
You actually sound good when we try.
It's too far away for me to hold. Too far away.
Made fun of that one, dude. Why'd we make fun of it?